not plug the headphones in, you.
Where nothing can possibly go wrong. That's strange, well, that's the first thing that's ever gone wrong.
Ball played forward from Stephen Trench into the penalty area, chested down by Danny Hall, picked up here by Adam Boyce towards the left-hand side of the penalty area, gets it back in, Liam Dickinson, oh, Nicky Marshall! He has put the ball in on the edge of the six-yard box! Has Nicky Marshall turned this game round and perhaps, possibly sent Guiseley through to the Vanarama Conference?
Good afternoon and welcome to Nethermore. It is D-Day for the Lions. Only a win will really do this afternoon, and Guiseley will be relying on favours from Macclesfield and Welling if they are to secure a second crack at the Vanarama National League. Last week's defeat at Boreham Wood, coupled with results elsewhere, leave the Lions a point away from safety and relying on their rivals to slip up. Boreham face Welling away, Halifax travel to Macclesfield, and Altrincham face Braintree. We'll be across all three games. The Lions have an uphill task to remain in the top flight of non-league football, and hey, we never have done things the easy way, have we? Now, one bit of good news is today's visitors, Torquay, are guaranteed safety. That in itself is remarkable for a team that looked dead and buried. The wheel is spinning still for Guiseley, and we here at Guiseley Radio don't hear any fat ladies just yet. The Great Escape is very much on. We'll be here for every moment. Tweet us at Guiseley Radio and hold on to your crockery. It's going to be a tense one.
Norburn goes for goal. Oliver Norburn! What a hit! All of 35 yards out. He had the sighter earlier. That is an absolutely stunning strike.
Good afternoon, or should I say good evening, for this rather delayed kick-off this afternoon here at Nethermore. I can tell you now the weather is clear, it is bright, there's a bit of a chill in the air, but we are all set for a good game of football this afternoon, and it could not be more crucial for the Lions this afternoon. Only a win will really do, and then we are relying on results elsewhere to go our way. The teams are in, and joining me to have a quick look through those teams, I'm joined this afternoon by Chris Bell. Chris, how are your nerves this afternoon?
Next question.
It's fair to say there it's a tense atmosphere, certainly up in this press box anyway.
Yeah, absolutely. We were saying earlier, we've gone through the cycles of how we're feeling and what's going to happen. You just don't know. At the end of the day, the very least we have to do really is go out there, give a performance that the Guiseley fans can at least be proud of, even if things don't go our way elsewhere. You know, we need to go out there and give what we hope will be a slightly bumper crowd a really good send-off to what has been, apart from the last 13 games, a decent season.
Yeah, you know, if you'd have said at the beginning of the season that we'd be going into the final game of the season still with a shot of survival, I think we could have done a lot worse, certainly, and this team has... you know, I think maybe perhaps we overachieved at the beginning of the season. Would that be fair to say?
I personally, no. I mean, when you look at what we've done, we've taken 16 points since Christmas, which tells its own story.
Well, yeah, since Christmas, obviously, but I'm talking about the beginning of the season.
But if we had a good start like that, why couldn't we have done it in the second half? I think, we've just dwindled away in a pretty pitiful manner. One win in 13 tells its own story, and we've taken a couple of good draws in there, don't get me wrong, but we've also thrown points away. Chester, we threw that away I expect we've done the same over the course of this week, which is dragged, by the way, this week, is that how many times have we gone back through the fixture list and thought, if only we'd have got that point there at this point here. But as it is, we're in this situation. We've got to go out there, we've got to put on a performance to be proud of and do everything we can at least and hope that things go for us.
Well, certainly the Lions this afternoon do have to hold up their end of the bargain, and the teams are in. Now, our opponents today, Torquay United, looked dead and buried at Christmas. They, for all the world, looked like they were heading for a second relegation down into the National League South. But a quite remarkable turnaround with their manager, with a change of manager, Kevin Nicholson, coming in, and he's brought them back from the brink.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you know, you say they were Denver at Christmas. Even in February, they were 12 points adrift in February, and it has been an absolutely remarkable run for Kevin Nicholson's side. And as you say, that change of manager there, in particular, was the catalyst for that. You know, Kevin Nicholson is somebody who was a Torquay left back for many a year in the Football League as well, and is somebody that's Torquay through and through. He's come in, he steadied the ship, he got rid of those that he didn't want, he's brought in some that he did, and changed the squad slightly, and to great effects. And, you know, credit to Torquay and to Kevin Nicholson in particular. You know, they've got a good travelling following here for this final game of the season, a long way to come for the final game of the season for a side that has no fears of anything. But, you know, they're going to want to end the season on a high note, and in particular for Kevin Nicholson, with talk around his job as well, he'll be keen to get the result.
Well, the teams are in this afternoon. We'll just have a quick look through the Torquay team. In goal, Brendan Moore, then Aman Verma, Daniel Butler, Ben Gehring, Courtney Richards, Exodus Gia Hagen, Toby Ayala, Luke Young, Sean Harrod, Nathan Blissett, and Sam Shaney. And I apologise for my pronunciation if that was wrong. You can tweet us this afternoon at Guiseley Radio if we do mispronounce anything. Do let us know. On the subs bench today for Torquay, Grant Fisher, Josh Rees, Danny Rackey, Kevin Nicholson, and Andre Wright. So he's named himself on the bench.
Yeah, well, why not? Last game of the season. Also, Danny Rackey, somebody that we had on trial in pre-season as well. He played against Ossett Albion, I think it was, that we had in pre-season. He was also on the books of Halifax earlier this season, and has publicly said he'd be quite happy to send us down.
Oh, that's nice.
Well, actually, he said he'd be quite happy to help out Halifax.
Well, hey.
But, you know.
You know, I'm sure he's not alone in hoping that we don't make it today. I'm sure all the Halifax supporters and all the Boreham Wood supporters will be Torquay fans this afternoon as well. But, hey, that's just football, isn't it? Guiseley team is in, and in goal, Stephen Drench, Ryan Toulson, Ben Parker, Danny Lowe, Jake Lawler, Adam Boys, Will Hatfield, Ollie Johnson, Rob Atkinson, Adam Smith makes a long overdue return, and Anthony Dudley. On the bench, Adam Lockwood, Tom Craddock, Gavin Rothery, Dan Atkinson, and Emil Sinclair. So I guess the headline from that is no James Hurst, no Oliver Norburn.
Yeah. I'm not sure how to react to that, if I'm completely honest. Oliver Norburn is a very puzzling one. Unless something's happened in the warm-up, in that's all I can expect, because he came off the bench and was fine when he came off. I mean, we drove back up on the team coach and he had no injury worries there. He was, you know, absolutely fine. So unless something's happened in training this week or in the warm-up today that we're not aware of, I am, if I'm completely honest, I'm very disappointed not to see him in the lineup, because he is that ball-playing midfielder who can make things happen. Or he can, you know, I mean, he's got such good feet to get himself out of tight situations. As I say, it's a little bit disappointing. Flipping that over, though, I am pleased to see Adam Smith return, because he's somebody who, since he arrived, he's been out with injury a couple of times. He was then out with illness as well, and he's really struggled, to be honest, to get into the side. However, one of his few appearances in recent weeks, well, I say recent weeks, a couple of months back now, Old Trim away, had a blinding game. Really good game in what was a very difficult conditions. So something for me that potentially, if ever there was a chance to prove yourself with contracts to be won as well, of course, today's the day to do it.
Well, that's the team that's been put out by Mark Bauer. And of course, last week's result was very disappointing. But we did speak to Mark after that game.
Possibly an afternoon where everything that could go wrong has gone wrong, results and wise. We're in the bottom four tonight. Thoughts after today's performance?
Disappointed on many different levels, really. You know, I said before, can't rely on other results. We had, I mean, the second half today, we just had so many chances to not just draw but win. Should have been outside, should have been 3-4-1. But again, an absolutely scandalous refereeing decision with a handball for the penalty. Everybody in the ground seen it, everyone on the pitch has seen it, and how we cannot give it is beyond me. He's the same referee that we had at Welling, who turned down another Stonewall penalty. But even then, we should have scored with the chances that we had. We're completely dominant. We should have scored goals. And if you don't take chances, you end up in this position that we're in, and we're falling into the bottom four. Having not been there all season, it's you know, a hard one to take. But we're there, and the only thing we can do now is go and win next week, and cross our fingers that things go our way elsewhere.
Second half performance was full of a lot of energy, a lot of drive, and You know, like you say, we had all our best chances in that half. Do you think we were missing that in the first?
I think we're a bit nervous first half, and you know, games take a little bit of time to settle. I thought we were scrappy there probably as a home team, and you know, they were probably a little bit more on the front foot than we were. But even then, apart from the goal they scored, I can't remember him creating anything or cutting us open. I had a few words at half time, and obviously came out with a bit more purpose. And you know, within 2-3 minutes of the second half kicking off, we should have been 2-1 up. But yeah, we've got to take our chances. You know, when you're coming away from home, you might get 2 or 3 chances, and you'd be ruthless and take them. But we've had glorious chances. Keeper's pulled off a couple of worldly saves, hit the underside of the crossbar. Should have had a stop, you know, penalty, and we've just got to pick ourselves up and go again. And bitterly disappointed, but you know, we can't think it's over. We've got to go and look to get the win next weekend and put the pressure on the other teams that are in the same boat as us.
And obviously it comes down to that last fixture then against Torquay. How do we set ourselves for that?
We've just got to win. We've just got to go and win. We there's no, you know, it's not a case of worrying about what's going on elsewhere. We've just got to go and win the game, and if we create the chances we had second half, we play like we did second half, we should do. But if we're not going to stick it in the net, it's going to be, it makes it so difficult. And you can't really, you know, fault anything else. You look at the game as a whole, got in so many good areas, so many good chances, that it's just that final touch, it's deserted us for a majority of the season, and it's really has stung us today.
Mark Bauer after the game against Boreham Wood last Saturday. Chris, you and I travelled down to that one. It was a disappointing one, wasn't it?
Yeah, very much so. I mean, we were hoping for at the very least a point, which, you know, it would have put us in a better position than what we're in now. As it was, the first half just didn't have the urgency it needed. The second half was a lot better. We hit the crossbar, a couple of minutes into the second half, then there was a handball decision that didn't go our way. One of those where when you see the replay on like BT Sports on the highlight show, you think, how was that not given? But at the time, none of us in the press box really saw it or called it.
We did. I think Mark...
Only Mark did, really.
Mark spotted it and was angrier about it than I think we were at the time. It's one of those ones that it happens at pace, happens at speed. The referee only gets one look at it. He doesn't call it. You know, we'll have a look at it, like you say, on the slow motion replay and go, well, that's obviously a penalty. It's just one of those. But the chances were there in that second half, and certainly Rob Atkinson hit the crossbar. Ollie Johnson had a chance. Adam Boyes had a chance. Anthony Dudley had a glorious
story of the season, though, isn't it, Dave?
It's just finding a way of putting the
chances,
ball
chances
into the back of the net. Well, it's Chris, it's 5:05.
It is.
Which is throwing us
yet
horribly because we haven't started. So we've been thinking, we're looking forward to a full afternoon's programme of football. Of course, that full afternoon's programme of football is now finished, and it is just National League games being played all at the same time. So, right, just because we would anyway, we'll have a little quick go through the National League North, because it was their final day today, and there were still some things to be settled, including the final playoff places. And I can tell you now, those playoff places will be taken by North Ferriby, Fylde, Harrogate and Boston. We'll be playing off for a place in the National League next season. And going through the results, Brackley 1, Tamworth 0, Bradford Park Avenue 1, Gainsborough 4, Chorley, could have been us, might be us again, 2-1 against Telford, Harrogate 5, Corby 0, Lowestoft 1, Gloucester 1, North Ferriby 0, Alfreton 1, Nuneaton 3, Hensford 0, secures their place, Stalybridge 0, Boston 5, Stockport 0, Curzon Ashton 0, FC United of Manchester 2, Solihull 2, and Worcester 2, Fylde 2. So, looking at the table then, Solihull are promoted as champions on 85 points, North Ferriby on 76, Fylde on 75, Harrogate on 72, Boston on 71, and Nuneaton, despite a thumping victory today, just miss out on 70 points.
Other score, Salford beat Workington 3-2, by the way, in the EvoStick playoff final, so they'll be into the Conference North for next season.
So that's everybody's favourite second team, Gary Neville, Salford. Is it Gary Neville or is it Phil Neville?
It's all of them, isn't it?
Is it
it's the
of
class
them?
Of 92s.
Oh, right, okay. So
Scholesy and Nicky Buck.
Good for them. Oh, Priestley scored for them as well. Let's see. Interesting. If you're interested in that sort of thing, I can tell you that York got beaten 4-1 by Bristol Rovers. Of course they did. And in League One, Bradford were playing away at Southend, and their long trip is
Was it
rewarded?
Or not?
Is the word? Yeah, that's the word. I'm like, oh, good grief! It's going to be one of those afternoons, isn't it? Bradford have won that game by 1-0, and Leeds have been beaten 2-1 at home by bottom team and already relegated Charlton. If you're interested in that sort of thing, of course. We here at Guiseley Radio, we have an extended team. Part of that extended team is Radio Yorkshire's Tom Feeney. Tom, you were there at Chorley a year ago. You remember it well. You and I sat next to each other and embarrassed ourselves in a press box. What are the chances of a repeat this afternoon, Tom?
Well, I think we're going to embarrass ourselves whatever happens. But, I mean, you know, look, it does feel, you know, we were speaking beforehand and you said that it felt like it was almost that half time where we were 2-0 down. It were our backs against the wall. And it feels like that already. We need to get a result today and hope, you know, hope and pray something goes our way elsewhere. But got to say, you know, credit to Macclesfield. It looks like they've put out their strongest team available. So, you know, maybe they'll be able to do us a favour at Halifax. But it's going to be a tough game. And you look at the Torquay fans, they've come as minions. And, you know, they're going to enjoy the day, hopefully. We'll be able to get the 3 points and they can have their fun elsewhere.
Are you sure they're minions, Tom? Because their top is yellow.
I mean, I saw minions.
Right, they might just be wearing dungarees. You don't know.
I will say I went on the Torquay Twitter and they have said that they were planning as minions. So from minions. This area, yeah. I'm not sure, but it doesn't like it.
To be fair, I've just how much effort do you have to be a Torquay fan and a minion? Not a great deal.
Well, it depends. Have you travelled up on the coach dressed as a minion? You know, those National Express coaches, there's not a lot of leg room at the best of times. You put a minion costume into the mix.
You would need to be a minion to fit in the spaces.
You would need to be tiny, you know, or a train. You know, it's the same thing. They're going to struggle. But I tell you what, Torquay have turned up in numbers this afternoon, and credit to them for that. Their season got turned around, Tom, and yet they're still bringing, you know, they're safe, and yet they're still bringing like nearer 300 fans this afternoon. That's good, isn't it?
Yeah, it's fantastic. And I mean, it's interesting that if Torquay hadn't have gone on the run that they've been on, there's a chance this game would have been the televised game, because this could have been the battle to see who stayed up. But Torquay were able to get the job done a couple of weeks ago. They've been in a great run of form, and I think the thing is, for their manager, he's promised them a performance, because like you said, it's a horrible journey, you know, such a long distance, and them fans will be coming here, you know, they'll be wanting a good time and they're going to have that, but they'll be expecting a performance as well. They won't expect the players to just be putting their feet up today.
Well, let's rather hope it's more Torquay than Cheltenham, hey? More Wrexham rather than Cheltenham. Oh.
It really is going to be one of those afternoons, isn't it?
It really is going to be one of those afternoons. We are a nervous bunch this afternoon. But look, there's a lot to go through. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to hand you over to my colleague David Kendra, who's going to take you through all the last day permutations.
David Kendra here from Guiseley Radio, going through the permutations for the final day as Guiseley face Torquay in the Vanarama National League with survival at stake. Altrincham are the side in most danger. They need to beat Braintree and hope that Guiseley fail to win and Macclesfield beat Halifax if they're to survive. Guiseley need to better the results of both Halifax and Altrincham in order to survive. Now, a draw might be enough if Macclesfield get a result at Halifax and Altrincham don't win at Braintree. Halifax know to win against Macclesfield will keep them up. A draw might be enough if Guiseley lose and Altrincham don't win. If Macclesfield beat Halifax, Guiseley lose and Altrincham fail to win, then the Shaman would still survive. Get a draw or a win and Guiseley beat Torquay and Boreham Wood would be relegated. A draw for them at already relegated Welling would be enough to secure survival, providing both Guiseley and Halifax don't win, while a win absolutely guarantees it. Kidderminster and Welling have already gone. Get it? Got it? Good.
I don't know who that chap was, but he was much more professional.
Much, much better. We are talking... We've been talking about our extended Guiseley Radio team, and of course one of the regular voices that you'll hear on Guiseley Radio is Nick Keefe, and he's joining us this afternoon. Nick, how do you feel about this afternoon?
Horrible?
I mean, pessimistic,
doesn't,
Nick.
Doesn't everybody?
Cutting edge radio here.
Yeah, horrible. Right, but come on, we've got a chance. This is half time at Chorley, isn't it, Nick?
Yeah, and this is how I sounded then as well.
You're never going to be able to show your face in the club shop again, are you?
I haven't been able to for the last year. Every time I've walked past Mark and Danny for the last year, I've been accused of doubting them and giving up too easily. So, no, it's fine. It's a beautiful day, good turnout. Let's get 3 points against the team playing in their flip-flops and take relegation on the chin with grace.
So wow. you're not particularly hopeful of a result from Macclesfield or Welling this afternoon?
Well, if I felt hopeful, then I'd be disappointed come full-time. Whereas if I keep it this way and it does... Something unexpected does happen, then
it's
that'll
a
be nice, won't it? But look, mate, I've spent the whole day in the White Rose Centre. It's hard to feel too cheerful about life, no matter how good the weather is.
I should also say Nick stood right next to his fiancée there, so that is dangerous, dangerous talk.
football,
right? This is what it does to us: misery, depression,
despair.
Remember, it's not the hope that kills you, it is the despair. You can tweet us this afternoon at Guiseley Radio with whatever it is that you're doing. Hello.
Maybe
hello.
Something more optimistic than Nick Keith.
Hey, well, look, here we've got Dinglebird here. She's listening in from Leicester, and hey, she's got a party ahead of her tomorrow afternoon anyway. She says, hi there, guys from Leicester. Huge day today for the Lions. Huge day for Leicester. Something about Leicester as well at the end of that tweet. Something about them winning the Premier League or something. Well,
what's that?
Good for them. But we've also got a few other tweets. You've been retweeting us as well. Tom Harvey says, two top quality sides. We can easily get the 3 points today. And James Headley has always been a big fan of those who like to send their fans off into the summer after a win. Well, let's hope that you're a big fan again tonight, James. Don't forget, you can tweet us through the game with at Guiseley Radio on the Twitter feed. Chris, can you take us through the other fixtures that are happening today?
Yeah.
There are other fixtures happening in the National League this afternoon.
Absolutely, there is more than Nethermore, it seems. We'll go through all of them. Barrow are at home to Wrexham. Braintree host Aldrian. Bromley host Aldershot. Lincoln City will be hoping to spoil the promotion party, but somehow I doubt it. They are away at Cheltenham. Chester at home to Gateshead. Dover welcome Forest Green. Of course, two sides there that may yet meet each other in the playoffs. Of course, we welcome Torquay to Nethermore. Macclesfield travel to the Shay. Southport host Kidderminster. Tranmere play Grimsby. Of course, everything isn't entirely certain for that final playoff spot. So if Tranmere get a result there and Braintree were to lose to Aldrian, Tranmere, I believe, would get that final playoff spot. Of course, Welling host Boreham Wood and Woking welcome Eastleigh. What stands out for you there, Dave? Excluding well, Halifax v Macclesfield and Welling versus Boreham Wood, which we kind of know about. What stands out?
Altrincham versus Braintree.
I missed that one.
Because obviously Altrincham, if they win and results go their way, they still have an outside chance of staying up. I mean, it's goal difference. They would have to rely on Halifax losing and us losing. To stay up, and also beating Braintree, which is a task in itself, but for against a team that are going to hold out and try and hang on to that last playoff place, you know. So
yeah,
that's going to be one to look out there. Just to keep half an eye on that one. Obviously, our main attention will be here at Nethermore and also the Boreham Wood and Halifax games.
I think Eastleigh could technically also make the playoffs, although I think goal difference would keep them out. Actually.
Well, there's a lot going on Nethermore today. Earlier today, the chairman of Guiseley AFC, Phil Rogerson, signed the Army Covenant with Warrant Officer Stephen Ingle, and we tweeted about that earlier. Follow us at Guiseley AFC. But also happening today is the presentation of the Craig Shearston Supporters Club Player of the Year, and I spoke to Paul, the treasurer of the Supporters Club, earlier today.
David Kendra here for Guiseley Radio. I'm here with Paul, treasurer of the Guiseley AFC Supporters Club. He's selling 50-50 tickets and Supporters Players of the Year nominations at the clubhouse this afternoon. Paul, how are you feeling?
Pretty good. Myself, everybody I've spoken to today, we're all confident that we can win today. The other results go for us and we stay up, obviously, you know, because we've had a very good season. We've enjoyed every minute. Wherever we've been this season, we've been welcomed it's been tremendous, and we want it to carry on.
Fantastic, and certainly Guiseley have enjoyed some fantastic support this season. We took, I think it was 113 we took to Boreham Wood the other week, so I'm sure the players have appreciated that. And also there's the, you're nominating the Player of the Year award this year. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, we do it every, we've done it for the last 3 years now, doing the Player of the Season award. Obviously, we're doing it differently this year because it means more, because it will be called the Craig Shearston Supporters Player of the Season. And we just felt it was fitting to do that. We've had the trophy re-enamelled. Well, it's completely a new design on it, and it looks very good. And hopefully, the player who gets it today will appreciate what's behind it, actually.
And just finally, Paul, prediction for this afternoon, scoreline.
Well, as long as it's a Guiseley win, honestly, I'm not bothered. A 90th minute winner will do me. Let's just stay up.
Paul, the treasurer of the Supporters Club, obviously they're presenting the Supporters Club Player of the Year in honour of Craig Shearston. They've got themselves a new trophy and they're going to present that to the Player of the Year. Chris, for what it's worth, who would be your Player of the Year?
Well, we had this discussion, didn't we, on the way back from Boreham Wood on the coach. There's a few potential candidates for that, I think. Will Hatfield, somebody that's been very consistent over the course of the season. You could equally give it Stephen Drench as well, you know, long-serving player of the club, but without him we'd be in a much worse position. At one stage of the season he was the goalkeeper that had made the most saves in the league, which probably says quite a bit about our defence, but without him being there to make those saves we'd be in, you know, in a worse position. So there's a couple of candidates. If I was forced to pick a name though, it would be Will Hatfield. I think he has just been Mr. Consistent, and for me he's definitely been the standout signing that was made last summer, and it's been ever present this season. Who would yours be?
Well,
if you had to pick someone different,
I can't argue with Will Hatfield as a nomination. I can't help feeling Rob Atkinson was overlooked in your summary there. I think he's, you know, for all our troubles in defence this season, he probably has been one of the most consistent. And I think one of the more underrated players, Danny Lowe.
Yes, Danny Lowe.
He's played left back. He's played centre back this year. I've never seen him have a very bad game. You know, I've seen him have better games and less better games, but. You know, he's been pretty much an ever-present all season, and a real asset to the side. And in terms of energy and enthusiasm, I don't think he's ever let the shirt down.
I think you've just convinced me to change my mind to Danny Lowe. No, to be fair, you're quite right, actually, because at the start of the season, he was, if I'm completely honest, somebody that I wasn't entirely sure whether they would make the step up. But actually, he's really impressed me overall over the course of the season that he has been capable of making that step up. And, you know, it is a big step. And I say a lot of the lads have done it well, to be fair. We need them to do it one more time today. But, as I say, for me, there's a you could pick one of probably five players that could get that trophy.
Well, we shall find out in the clubhouse after the game. You can join us. There is a party going on. We will tell whether that's a party or a moratorium. And we will be able to tell you that in a couple of hours, depending on what happens in the next little passage of time. The Torquay fans are here in number. There is quite a turnout this afternoon at Nethermore. It is full on all three sides. It's exactly the sort of crowd that we needed this afternoon. We are, of course, collecting for the Bobby Moore Fund as well. Here there's red buckets going around Nethermore. And we are joined this afternoon as well by the winners of the FA Vase from 1991. Some of the squad members there are also here. But the teams are making their way out onto this Nethermore pitch for this most important of games. 3 points is all that is required, is the least that is required. Come on, you Lions, is all we can say at this point. A win and favours from elsewhere will see Guiseley secure a second season in the Vanarama National League. Taking you through this afternoon, Chris, I'll just ask you for your final thoughts before this game, and then we'll be joined by your match commentator, Colin Robertson.
Yes, cheers, Dave. What an afternoon. It's a beautiful day here at Nethermore Park. Can Guiseley get that all-important win, though? That is the question. I think we've got the capability of doing it. There's some players on there that need to stand up and be counted there, though. And if we can get that win, we'll be keeping an eye on scores elsewhere, of course. But Colin, a big afternoon for Guiseley.
Yeah, thank you, Chris. It is indeed a huge afternoon for the Lions here at Nethermoor. Sunny Nethermoor, where our visitors from the seaside on the south coast have arrived and are in party mood, having secured their own safety. Can the Lions join them in the party tonight? It's an absolutely huge occasion at Nethermoor. There is fans clustered around every part of this ground as the referee and the players shake hands and the home crowd begin to urge their side on. That trip down to Torquay back in the early parts of this season, the Lions drew 1-1. It was a Liam Dickinson penalty on that day, but really and truth, Chris, we should have won, shouldn't we, on that afternoon?
How many times can we say that? That definitely was one of those games there on the day. We only got a point when we really should have had all three, because the first half we absolutely dominated. And as you say, we should have come away from the South Coast with all 3 points. It is a vastly different Torquay side now, though, to the one we faced back then.
So let's just go through those two sides then. For the Lions, Steve Drench in goal, Ryan Toulson, Ben Parker, captain, Danny Lowe, Jake Lawler, Adam Boys, Will Hatfield, Ollie Johnson, Rob Atkinson, Adam Smith and Anthony Dudley. On the bench, Adam Lockwood, Tom Craddock, Gavin Rothery, Dan Atkinson, Emile Sinclair. No place for Oliver Norburn, no place for Hurst either. James Hurst is also missing from this squad. For Torquay, they line up as follows: Brendan Moore, Amon Verma, Daniel Butler, Ben Gehring, Courtney Richards, Exodus Geohagen, who scored the goal against us to equalise in the return fixture, Toby Ajala, Luke Young, Sean Harrod, Nathan Blissett and Sam Cheney. And on the bench, Grant Fisher, Josh Rees, Danny Rackey, Kevin Nicholson, the player manager, and Andre Wright. Just a touch on that lineup, Chris. What do you make of the Guiseley section? I'm sure you've been talking about that in the build-up, but that could be a big loss, couldn't it, Norburn and Hurst today?
Yeah, well, we'd been hoping to see James Hurst come back. You know, we'd been told that he missed the last couple of games in preparation, hopefully being fit for this one. Sadly, that's not the case. As I said to Dave early, for me, not seeing Oliver Norburn on that team sheet is frankly a massive disappointment. I'm absolutely gutted, because he's that kind of player that can keep possession and just keep things ticking over in midfield. And as I say, we can only presume it's an injury either picked up in training midweek or in the warm-up today, but he's a big loss, and there's some players in there that are going to have to really stand up and be counting. This is a real chance as well for Adam Smith, of course, making a long way to return to starting football.
So we get ready to kick off. Torquay, playing in all yellow, are going to be shooting from left to right, where we sit towards the bowling end green of the ground. The Lions attacking the railway end in white shirts, navy blue shorts, navy blue socks. Referee today, Ian Hussin, just doing the final checks before about to blow the whistle. He's going to be assisted by Mark Cunliffe and Ian Gittins. The fourth official today is Benjamin Speedy. And immediately Torquay punt the ball long towards the edge of the 18-yard box, looking to get Sean Harrod in to play. It's headed out and it's going to be a Torquay throw. Verma from right back steps up to take the throw and lofts it in towards the edge of the 18-yard box, headed away by Jake Lawler, but picked up well here by Ajala. He's lost out, though, to Dudley. Dudley can't get the ball away, though, and Ajala almost closes down Danny Lowe, who recovers the ball. And then there's a clearance all the way into the Guiseley half from Butler, and a punt from distance that gets Stephen Drench stretching down to his right to put the ball behind. And then it deflects off for a goal kick nonetheless. But an early moment there where Guiseley were under real pressure.
Yeah, absolutely. The effort from Sean Harrod. Bit of a snapshot. Took it on the half volley. Did well with his effort. Forced a good save from Stephen Drench. But it's a confident start from the visitors, as you'd expect, really, given their recent good form and the fact that they're just going out here to enjoy themselves on the last day of the season. But a little bit shaky at the back from Guiseley in the opening couple of minutes.
The goal kick has been taken and sent long by Drench towards the Torquay backline. Nodded on by Johnson towards Boys. Boys chases into the box, but it's well defended. Gehring getting a firm foot away. Dudley now on the left-hand side tries to cut infield, but he's held up by Amon Verma. Guiseley get the throw, taken quickly. Will Hatfield on the ball, steps on the ball slightly. goes back to Parker. Parker chips the ball up towards Dudley. Dudley finds Ollie Johnson on the edge of the D now. Johnson gives it to Hatfield. Hatfield finds some space, takes a shot, blocked by two lunging yellow shirts that managed to deflect the ball away, and now a counter-attack on for Torquay with Sam Cheney down the left-hand side. Cheney held up by Jake Lawler. Guys, they see the ball go back to the halfway line where Luke Young punts it forward into the box. Stephen Drench out, claims the ball and takes it down.
Well, we just saw that first glimpse really of Guiseley coming forward. Decent passing and movement that got Will Hatfield in. If it wasn't for some excellent blocking, Guiseley could have had the goal that they really want early on.
Clearance from Stephen Drench has been knocked out. Smith couldn't control. Drench holds his hands out in apology and it results in a Torquay throw. They can't work it down that left flank though. Gehring heading on towards the halfway line. Adam Smith now picks it up, but he's chased down. Smith punts it along the right flank. It's punted out of play. Long time since Adam Smith has started for Guiseley.
Altering him away.
That's an age ago, isn't it?
It was a long time ago. And to be fair, he was the best player in a Guiseley shirt on that occasion. Hasn't started since. He needs to have that kind of performance again today.
Toulson sends it towards the edge of the box. Helped away from Adam Boys by the Torquay back line once again. And then Luke Young gets it up towards the halfway line. Not surprisingly, the Lions trying to play with a high tempo now. Jake Lawler plays it to the right. Smith, closed down by two, works his way back in field. Loses out. He's challenged by Gio Hagen, I think, or Courtney Richards, rather, who came in a little late there. And it's going to be a free kick to Guiseley. Midway through the Torquay half out to the right.
Yeah, good work from Adam Smith. That's exactly what he'll want to try and do, is working around the defenders, try and get away from them, draw the fouls where he can. Look to get behind them. He did well that. And he's going to take this free kick as well.
Smith has got about six players to aim for on the edge of the 18-yard box. Free kick on this right-hand side. He's going to float it in towards the penalty spot over the white shirts and headed away by Torquay up to the centre circle now, where Harrod takes it down, but good battling from Will Hatfield wins the ball back for Guiseley before a firm interception lofts the ball over this main stand here and out for a Guiseley throw about on the halfway line.
Yeah, good work from Will Hatfield getting stuck in. Never want to shy out of a challenge, is he, Will Hatfield?
Ball short to Hatfield from the throw and it goes long. Now there's a header on. Ollie Johnson clean through a goal. One on one with the keeper. Tries to lob the keeper. It can't be kept out. Ollie Johnson gives Guiseley the lead. After 5 minutes, it's the Lions who have first blood in this all-important relegation battle. Guiseley 1, Torquay 0.
Get in there. Perfect start for the Lions. Ollie Johnson almost had too much time. He goes to lob the keeper. He gets something on it, does Brendan Moore, and you think he's going to tip it over, and then it drops, it dips just in front of the crossbar, and that is the perfect start for the Lions. Guiseley leading by a goal to nil. Yes, get in there, Cole.
85 minutes to go. I hate to be the bearer of bad news.
Blow the whistle, ref.
Full-time ref. Werner.
That's going to put the pressure on at the shake.
Free kick to Torquay anyway, just inside the visitors' half, just on the edge of the centre circle. There's only 5 minutes gone in this game, so I don't think there's been any score elsewhere. But a free kick now to Torquay, just inside their own half, and they're going to lock this one forward. There's players lining up on the edge of the 18-yard box. Played up by Verma, up towards the left-hand side. Can't be kept in play by Blissett. And it's out. There's going to be three words that we're going to use over and over again today, isn't it? As it stands.
I was going to bring a swear jar or the equivalent of an as it stands jar.
But we're going to be watching, aren't we?
We are. It was interesting, actually. I saw somewhere in midweek that Mark had basically admitted that he's going to be keeping an eye on scores elsewhere. And you do wonder in this situation what the best course of action as a manager would be.
Well, he might have to, with the goal difference being potentially an issue. I don't suppose it really is, but in all the permutations that we can come up with.
That's a word we haven't used before until this last week as well, permutations.
Torquay have a free kick now. It's just inside the Lions' half. Again, they're going to send it long, and again, they're going to get the bodies in and attack Guiseley. They've got five, six around the edge of the D, a seventh on the edge a little further back. This one's whipped in towards the penalty spot, headed away. Guiseley still lead by a goal to nil. Torquay pressing though, the ball up high in the air and beyond. And you can hear that that's gone probably from the reaction of the crowd quite tamely out of play and out for a goal kick.
Well, every time Torquay get a set piece, they send the likes of Exodus Geohagen, why wouldn't you, at 6'7", and Nathan Blissett as well, somebody who's over 6'5". There's a bit of height in this Torquay United side. So it's going to be certainly a handful for the likes of Jake Lawler, who so far has been picking up Blissett on both occasions. Certainly going to be a handful for the Guiseley backline.
Trench with the clearance. Headed 08. Nodded up in the air, away from Will Hatfield inside the centre circle, and taken down now by Sam Chaney for Torquay. A press though. Richards having to strain to keep ball in play and give it to Verma as Dudley, full of energy, chases down. The ball goes down the right-hand side. Ben Parker now up against Nathan Blissett on that right flank. Blissett wins the battle. Parker sticks to his task though, holds him up a little bit. Ollie Johnson with a super tackle wins the ball back for Guiseley, and now Guiseley can come away with it. Danny Lowe skips past one, but he's caught by the lunge of Luke Young. Free kick given. Young went to play the ball just a little late, clipped at Lowe, and now it's a free kick to Guiseley inside the Lions half.
Yeah, Lowe had done a decent job there. I think he probably got beyond, and if he just read the situation, probably could have jumped over that challenge and tried to continue, but as it is, free kick for Guiseley.
Nick Keefe just tweeting us there. It's going to be the hope that kills us, isn't it? As we're 1-0 up. The ball long, headed up in the air. Torquay can't get a good clearance, though. And Guiseley win a throw midway through the Torquay half. 8 minutes gone. That's all. And Guiseley are leading by a goal to nil. Danny Lowe on the ball for Guiseley. Gives it back to Ben Parker on the halfway. He tries to work down that left flank. Lowe now has the ball from a nod down from Boys. Lowe's into Adam Boys, tries to play a 1-2. It's been intercepted by Geohagen. Guiseley have a throw. The lead back in September didn't last all that long. It lasted about 5 minutes, so this one hasn't reached that yet. Guiseley have another throw-in on the left-hand side. It's Exodus Geohagen who got that equaliser, a scramble in the box. Back now with Ben Parker. He chips the ball towards the edge of the 18-yard box, headed out again by Gehring. Ben Gehring, a local lad from Torquay, came through the Plymouth Argyle youth system, proving himself to be a very solid, combative centre-half so far. Ben Parker now on the ball for the Lions, plays it forward, up towards the back post where Smith is chasing. It's somehow cleared by Torquay, brilliant piece of defending, but the Lions pick the ball up once again with Dudley trying to feed it through towards Boys. Boys not giving it up, forcing the pace and the tempo. The Lions hassling and forcing Torquay into areas now. Lowe chips the ball into the box, over Ollie Johnson, who has outstretched arms and saying, why don't you play it into my feet? The ball out of play now though, as Ajala tries to get out of his own half, and Guiseley win the throw.
Yeah, really good pressing from Guiseley at the moment. Just the one of the goals so far elsewhere. Southport 1, Kidderminster 0.
Now the ball over the top, Boys into the penalty area, out to the left hand side. He's been forced away, gets it across the face, a goal! Guiseley, yeah! Tap out! There's the second!
Will
Hammond have the second goal, and it's Adam Smith after Boys as the creator, and Guiseley have a second goal in this game. It's the Lions 2, Torquay 0.
Get in there, Guiseley. A brilliant start. Really good play as Adam Boys pulled it back across. And there was the man I mentioned for candidate of player of the season. If he keeps this up, surely he's a shoo-in. Will Hatfield to get the second goal for Guiseley. Guiseley leading by 2-0.
Brilliant. I thought it was Adam Smith in there. Will Hatfield, then, you sure on that?
Yes.
I couldn't see. There was about three or four guys just in front of me stood up brilliantly because the ball trickled to Hatfield inside the six-yard box. And we all knew what the end result was going to be from that point onwards. Guiseley now lead 2-0 here. What a huge afternoon. And it's so far working out so well. We'll keep you up to speed with all the scores elsewhere. Chris has got one to tell you about shortly, but it's gone back to the goalkeeper at the moment. Adam Boys chasing down goalkeeper Brendan Moore. He manages to get clear. Lowe picks up the ball, plays it into Ollie Johnson. He's bundled over by Geohagen. Free kick to Guiseley. This is like the Wrexham game, isn't it? In the pace that we have started and the pressure we are applying to the visitors today.
Yeah, we have got to keep this up, though. We need to at least make this count. 2-0, they always say, is the most dangerous scoreline.
Free kick, then, that will be taken. It's probably too far for an effort. Adam Smith looks like he's going to take the delivery.
He tried to take it quickly, then play it to Hatfield, so Hatfield could have a shot from distance. Referee wasn't happy with that, though.
He's going to swing this in towards the edge of the 18-yard box. Whips the ball up towards the back post. Headed back across the face. A goal held by the goalkeeper, though, Brendan Moore. And it rests in the goalkeeper's arms, who rolls it out to the left flank. And now Torquay in possession of the ball. Oh, they lose possession sloppily. Picked up now by Rob Atkinson. Ollie Johnson doesn't run with the flight of the ball quite well enough. Hatfield tries to win it back off Courtney Richards. Richards now chips it forward. In towards the edge of the 18-yard box. Torquay, incisive move forward here, and eventually helped away before Nathan Blissett can get on to the end of that one. And Guiseley get it into the Torquay half, but Torquay win possession back now, moving down this right-hand side. Nothing to play for other than professional pride for the visitors today. Safe after looking for a long time in this season as a team that were going down, but they're certainly going about their task as best they can. But they're being outfought at the moment by a Guiseley side full of energy. Dudley just can't get on the end of that. The ball seemed to hang up a little bit more as the ball forward from Jake Lawler just rolled past Dudley and then through to the hands of Brendan Moore. Till 2-0 to Guiseley, if you're just joining us. The Lions having a superb start in this game. Is that a collision? I think that's taken Ben Parker out by Blissett. Nathan Blissett went in for the aerial challenge with Ben Parker, and he's gone to ground, and he doesn't look comfortable, does he?
Blissett effectively came down on top of him, went over the top of him, and as Parker was down on the ground, Blissett effectively just landed on top of him. It's just an unfortunate accident more than anything. He's rolled back onto his front at least, so as he tries to sit up.
He's on his feet. Referee's not allowing the introduction of Martin Stringfellow. So
whilst we've got this stoppage, the only other game with goals, Southport Kidderminster, that's now 1-1. Kidderminster have equalised there.
No goals elsewhere. No goals elsewhere. As it stands, the Lions would be safe. But, of course, there's an awful lot of football yet to be played this afternoon. 15 minutes gone. Guiseley 2-0 up against Torquay. And still pressing. Now the ball out to the right-hand side. Smith will chase. This will roll out for a corner if it goes. It does indeed. And Guiseley win a corner on the right-hand side. It all came from Stephen Drench's long ball forward. And the fullback, Daniel Butler, didn't judge the flight of the ball and knocks it out for a Guiseley corner. This is a chance for the Lions to get bodies into the box. Press for this third goal. Every single effort will count now. Waiting for the ball to be played. Guiseley have six in the area. It's played in from this right-hand side by Smith up towards the edge of the six-yard box. But Brendan Moore does ever so well to claim the ball. Distributes it very quickly down the left-hand side. It's a chance here for Ajala to get forward now for Torquay. Ajala on the left flank up against Hatfield. Plays it in towards the edge of the D. Picked up now by Cheney. Cheney back out to the left-hand flank. Butler picks it into the box. Headed away by Hatfield. Ollie Johnson has to chase to try and win the ball. He tips it through the legs of Richards and then gives it to Lowe, who plays a long one forward, and Boyes is chasing ever so hard. Boyes trying to win the ball back. Takes it past the defender. And oh, the referee decides that's a slight nudge on Gio Hagen and gives the free kick rather kindly to Torquay. But I have to say, there wasn't an awful much of contact between the two.
There wasn't much. I think there might have been a slight push. What nearly got me off my seat was the attempted finish from Boyes. He just flicked the outside of his right foot in midair. The goalkeeper got something on it anyway, but can we have to keep this up, but can we keep this up is the hard thing.
Tense isn't the word. Ball's picked up by Young. Played out to the left-hand side. Butler. Butler plays it into the box. Out goes Drench. Great claim underneath the ever-aerial presence of Nathan Blissett. But a super claim from the Guiseley keeper.
Elsewhere, Woking 2, Eastleigh 0.
Two quick fire goals there then. Guiseley pressing once again. The ball being nodded about between the back line and back into the hands of Brendan Moore. Superb start from the Lions to this game. Ollie Johnson after 4 minutes, and then Will Hatfield after 10 has given Guiseley a 2-0 lead.
Bromley 0, Aldershot 1 is another score from elsewhere. As things are though, still 0-0 between Halifax and Macclesfield. and Welling and Boreham Wood. And Braintree and Altrincham as well, come to mention it.
Yeah, it's a funny one, isn't it? That you just have to keep your eye on that one as well, because of course Altrincham, were they to beat Braintree, could overcome all the sides as well, should results go in their favour. The throws now placed down the right flank as it goes up towards Dudley. But it's headed out. And it's going to be a throw-in for Toulson. Toulson into the feet of Smith. Smith to Toulson. Toulson square now. Gives it to Lawler. Lawler sprays the ball across field. Chested down here by Ollie Johnson. Well, good control from Ollie Johnson. On the left-hand flank of the penalty box. Gives it here to Hatfield. Enfield now to Jake Lawler. Back to the left flank and Danny Lowe's collected. Looks to cross. Gets it up towards the back post. Look, Johnson leaps. But goalkeeper Moore claims and immediately sends the ball forward, because Torquay want to catch Guiseley on the counter-attack and they press down the left flank and the ball's up towards Harrod now. Harrod to the left side. Now goes back into the area as Torquay again get the ball to the striker. His control keeps things ticking over for Torquay on the left-hand flank, but Guiseley have bodies back and are in numbers now and are hassling and harrying Torquay at every occasion. Anthony Dudley working ever so hard to win the ball back, and the referee's given a free kick against him, though. Again, that looks a bit soft.
Yeah, I think that is soft. I think it was just the fact that he just didn't give him a minute's peace there, did he? He kept plugging away. Just can consider himself unfortunate there, I think, to concede the free kick.
And it's in a dangerous position as well. Central, in the middle of the Guiseley half, about 15 yards from the edge of the D. The Lions, well, about 10 yards from the edge of the Lions, are manning a five-man wall there. Torquay have four lurking around on the edge of the 18-yard box. And Richards, who's going to strike this one, possibly. There's two looking to take this. Possibly too far for a shot. But it looks like they might be shaping up to do just that. The referee blows the whistle. The ball is struck straight into the wall. Helped away by Smith, but it's blocked. And then goes kindly back into the area from Torquay perspective. But well shielded, well defended by Atkinson. And away by Smith, up towards Dudley. But won back by Butler for Torquay. And another free kick is given. And again, the groans go around the ground, because this time Luke Young goes to ground. I don't think even Dudley came close to him there.
Nah, not really, not at all. There's been a goal that does count for us. Braintree 1, Altrincham 0 is the latest score from Cressing Road.
So that's one in our favour. Torquay will take it, although it's not a big one. It's a poor ball from the free kick taker, and it's a chance for Smith to intercept. He sends it a bit too long, though. It's a poor ball, actually, from Adam Smith. He had a more of an option, really, but he's just returned it to Brendan Moore, the Torquay United goalkeeper. Guys, he managed to get themselves out of their line, but Torquay are pressing and wanting to get back into this game. Not surprisingly, the Lions gonna have to work hard. This Torquay side have been in great form. Geoghegan wins the ball off Dudley, plays it forward. Jala back now to the feet of Verma. His ball long down the right channel, chested down well by Harrod. Battling and trying to get past Ben Parker, but Carker's too wily for it. Gives it to Danny Lowe. Ollie Johnson on defensive duties. Ships the ball down the left channel. Run on for Adam Boyes up against Geoghegan. Boyes is held back, but he's managed to keep the ball ticking over. Gives it to Dudley. Dudley helps it across to Smith. Smith now on the ball. Holds it up. Goes past one. Tries to cut infield. Takes a shot on his left foot, but it's high and wide from Adam Smith. Well, it would have been something spectacular had he being able to strike it from that range, but in the end, I think that one's catching the 5:45 to Leeds.
I think he was looking for the headline maker there, wasn't he? He'd done the hard part, he cut inside really well. He was still a good 25 yards out at least before hitting it with the left hand side, and somehow it just seemed to get it vertical rather than any real horizontal distance. It eventually went out.
Lions now on the ball inside their own half and doing well again to regain possession. Ollie Johnson now moving forward down the right hand side. Two ahead of him. Ollie Johnson, two in front of him to beat. Does well, but can't get it through the two, and in the end it deflects and is away for Torquay United up to the halfway line. Counter attack again on Jake Lawler, working back, trying to heap pressure on Cheney. The ball threaded through towards Blissett. Once again, Ryan Toulson has to be on the top of his game to pick up the ball and shoot it out of play. It's going to be a throw in to Torquay, about on the halfway line.
How many gone?
Too little. 21. The ball played down that left channel, helped away by Atkinson. Oh, and it's hit someone in the crowd there. I think they didn't expect it to come out of the air like it did. And there's a bit of a knock to a person. I think they're okay. But that was quite a surprise, the way the ball just floated down out of the air and into the terracing. Guiseley, meanwhile, 2-0 up if you've just joined us. They are going to have to defend a throw right in front of the dugout. And you can see the intention from Torquay, the pressure that they want to apply. Because I'd say it's more sort of midway through the Lions' half. They're going to send this one long and into the box. There's a tremendous throw into the area. Helped away for a moment by Ben Parker. There's a shot that comes in, though, by Harrod, straight at Stephen Drench. And the Lions recover possession. Don't forget, you can tweet us at Guiseley Radio with your thoughts. So, too busy twitching to find out the scores of other games. But if you do, be delighted to hear from you. Header away now, picked up here by Jake Lawler on the edge of the six-yard box. Gives it to Toulson. Toulson and Lawler combine, play the ball down the right-hand side. Ollie Johnson takes over, up against two, keeps possession, gives it to Smith, goes for the return ball. Smith takes an audacious effort to try and catch the goalkeeper off the line, Brendan Moore. It was from a very difficult angle if he'd had a hope of doing so, because he was out by the touchline on the far right-hand side of the field, and in the end, it's behind for a goal kick.
Just the one tweet recently from Dinglebird. Oh, my goodness, this is not good for your nerves. And she's with that, she sent a picture that she's taking. She's watching the Altrincham and Braintree game. And she sent a picture, and it's come up. Goal flash, Guiseley 2, Torquay 0, Will Hatfield on the screen. Don't adjust your sets. This is the scoreline at Nethermoor.
We've scored.
Twice.
Torquay are now on the ball. And now there's a chance for the visitors here. Blissett picks it up on the left-hand side of the penalty area. Square to Harrod. Harrod will get a shot away. It's blocked. White shirt's trying to get the bodies on the line. Another one goes into the area. Takes deflection off to Danny Lowe. Claimed by Stephen Drench. Under pressure there from Nathan Blissett. And Guiseley will gratefully slow the game down for a second. And we're still watch these scores around the other games, but we have to keep an eye on this game. It's a blistering pace this game has started at, with the Lions leading by 2-0. Now with Anthony Dudley on the ball. Adam Smith on the right-hand side. It bobbles just in front of him awkwardly. Controls, though, Adam Smith, but he's lost a bit of his positional advantage. Now it's nice one in here towards Boys. Little flick on to Dudley, picked up by Smith. Smith's got the right-hand side with Ryan Toulson. Can Ryan Toulson deliver this cross? He can. Into the box. Headed away. Good defensive header from Gehring. Again, only as far as it will Hatfield. Hatfield recovers, sends it to the right-hand side again. Gets it back from Toulson. Some distance from goal now, Guiseley. But they're keeping the players in advanced positions. It's chipped down that right-hand side. Adam Smith goes chasing up against Butler. Butler shepherds it out for a goal kick, though. And it's another goal kick that I'm sure Brendan Moore will want to take quickly.
Another goal elsewhere, this one in the playoff race. Tranmere have taken the lead at Prenton Park at home to Grimsby. They lead by a goal to nil, of course, at the moment. Irrelevant due to Braintree leading against Altrincham, though. But Tranmere looking to keep the pressure on.
25 minutes gone.
Speaking of pressure on, I wonder how the nerves are at the Shea and at Parkview Road.
Welling.
To be fair, we're still full of them here, let's be honest. Yeah. There's a long way to go.
We've got to take care of our business. That's what Mark let me into the ground earlier on today. It's the first thing he sort of said to me. All we've got to do is take care of ours. And guys, you're doing so now at the moment. Dudley into the penalty area on the right-hand side. Drills it across the goal. Hits the woodwork and comes away. Brilliant effort from Anthony Dudley. But at an acute angle, he couldn't quite squeeze it into the net. Guiseley almost getting a third. They've now hit the upright. Anthony Dudley with some great work getting into the box. But the woodwork denying the Lions, still 2-0.
That was nearly flipping brilliant. Oh, great work from Anthony Dudley. That was, he danced around and away from three yellow shirts. So unlucky to see it hit the base of the far post.
Headed on by Ben Parker as Guiseley just win ball back again from Torquay. I'm sure they'll make some changes. Torquay United, it hasn't worked for them so far. The Lions should have been 3-0 up, but should have is one of those words we've used a lot this season. Let's hope that doesn't come back to haunt us. The ball forward, up towards Boys. He's never going to win that battle with Geohagen. His huge frame winning the header there. But guys, he win the second phase now with Toulson. Toulson on that right flank. Cuts infield, keeps going. Blocked, out for a throw. Lions will get a throw midway through the Torquay half on the right-hand side. Toulson will take, sends it down the right flank, gives it to Smith. Smith lobs it up in the air. Geohagen heads clear for Torquay, and now it's a chance for a counter-attack again, which is played swiftly forward towards Harrod. Good header from Rob Atkins, super header from the defender there, nodding it into Jake Lawler's path. And then Ollie Johnson just concedes possession with a difficult ball into his left foot. It bounces away from him. Now Verma for Torquay. He looks ahead of him, plays a high one in the air. It's a good one into the box. It finds the head of Harrod. He's goal-bound header, though, saved by Stephen Drench. A super ball in there from Eamon Verma. It curled into the 18-yard box and picked out Sean Harrod at the back post, but Stephen Drench was equal to it.
Yeah, Stephen Drench did well with that. He watched the cross come in. He took a step of his line at first, thinking about Quinn to claim the cross.
Dudley now gets on the ball, lobs it over. It's a bit too far for Adam Boys, but it was a good move there. Involved Dudley and Jake Lawler, but just a little bit heavy on the final touch from Anthony Dudley.
Nothing happening elsewhere so far.
And you keep looking at your watch and you think, there's another five that have gone and it's been about 30 seconds. Good entertainment for the neutral, but who'd be a neutral? Atkinson battling ever so hard, wins the ball, brings it up to the centre half. The centre half brings it up to the halfway line, and then the free kick is given for a nudge on him. But brilliant work again from Rob Atkinson. Super work to win the ball. And a free kick now for Guiseley inside their own half. Stephen Drench coming up to take this. It's only a matter of 2 yards from the edge of the centre circle. Always makes me nervous when he does this.
It's inside the Guiseley half. Don't get too worried. It is in the Guiseley half. But it's because of the delivery that he's got. You watch this one go straight out of play. Yeah. I've said that. Playing a high line though, Torquay, look.
Drench lobs it up in the air, up towards Dudley. He's never going to win that up against Geohagen. He's absolutely massive, Geohagen. Dudley gets second phase though, under pressure from the centre half. And it's whipped away. Atkinson alive to the danger of Sean Harrod again on the counter attack. Plays it to Lowe now. Lowe, few options. Chips it forward to for Ollie Johnson. Cuts in field, three around him. Ollie Johnson does well, but doesn't really find a player in space. And it'll roll all the way through to the left back, Daniel Butler. Up to the halfway line now. Atkinson battling to try and win it, but it's flicked on. Ben Parker tidies up. He helps it forward. And in the end, Gehring's got the header, but it's not a firm header, and it's picked up now by Boys into Hatfield. Hatfield slits it through. Dudley through a goal. Goes past the goalkeeper. 3-0! 3-0 to Guiseley. A brilliant, cool finish from Anthony Dudley. And the Lions have what surely must be a convincing, if not an unassailable lead. What a start from Guiseley. Guiseley 3, Torquay 0.
Wonderful stuff from Anthony Dudley again. Got himself into the right position. Onto the end of the perfect ball. And he just took it on the keeper, left Brendan Moore on his backside. He'd given up on it as soon as Dudley got round him. And he sticks it over the line before defenders can get back. The Lions lead by 3-0.
Well, whilst that's all going on, I lost my pen whilst I was rushing around. And I'm being very kindly handed it back. Thank you very much. I can't move because I'm all tied in.
And I think it's understandable.
Guiseley now.
To lose your pen when we're 3-0 up. We'll be the only
3-0 up with half an hour
rate
to go. Half an hour gone. Helped out to play now, Geohagen. I'm still nervous. Guiseley can't rest because it's still potentially an afternoon of misery if other results don't go our way. It's going to be nervy. But Ollie Johnson now on the ball for Guiseley. Takes it down to the corner flag. Gets it into the box. Helped away by Geohagen. It's going to be kept in play. But Ben Parker wins it back. Gives it to Jake Lawler. Lions square now to Hatfield. Hatfield can keep it ticking over on the halfway line to the right-hand side. Toulson. Toulson holds on to the ball a little bit, but he's overly pressed by Cheney. He has to go back. He can't go back because he's got himself into a really difficult position, but Ryan Tilson doing ever so well to keep on the ball, then gets it up towards the halfway line. Holly Johnson will chase, goalkeeper right out of his area, lofts the ball clear. Guisey with a 3-goal lead, just want to see the ball out into touch and to hold on to it. 31 minutes gone, and we've had 3 goals in the opening half hour, all to Guiseley, which is the perfect scenario. And as yet, we haven't seen a scoreline of concern to us.
Yeah,
but that could change yet in the next hour.
Still 0-0 at Welling v Boreham Wood and at FC Halifax versus Macclesfield.
Cheney on the ball now for Torquay as they look to respond to that 3-goal deficit that they now face. The ball into the feet of Richards, the captain. This isn't a Torquay side that have come to be rolled over by no stretch of the imagination. Butler on that left flank. It's been a super performance so far from Guiseley, but they've got quality in here. And Butler distributes it into the box, trying to pick out Ajala. Ajala, a good ball back into the area. Well claimed by Stephen Drench.
Yeah, that initial cross from Dan Butler, that's a lot more more like what we're used to seeing.
And now there's a bit of a confrontation in the area, as it looks like Atkinson and Blissett are going head to head. Referee just going to have a moment just to cool things down.
Nobody do anything stupid. Macclesfield has taken the lead at Halifax. Come on, yes! Macclesfield have scored. I hope this doesn't come up as a correction now, but as things are, according to my sources, and Boreham would have scored at Welling, that's not so good.
No, correction. It's not.
No,
it's not. You've read it too soon. Halifax 0-0. Halifax is still 0-0. So just be careful, Chris. These results come through. Halifax is still 0-0. It's not 1-0. It's been corrected. So we just have to watch the scorelines. But Boreham Wood have taken the lead against Welling. So Boreham Wood are 1-0 up. Halifax is still 0-0. Goal must have been ruled out. It's been played forward now, headed away by the centre-half, Gierhagen, headed up in the field by Hatfield, up towards Smith, now taken down by Boys. Boys out here to Smith. Smith on this right flank, cuts in field, plays a nice one in to find Boys on the edge of the D. He slips as he takes his shot, and it rolls through to the goalkeeper on that occasion, and immediately it's played forward. The rule of thumb here is just not to believe anything until it's been there for a couple of seconds at the moment. It's not your fault. Happens all the time. Guys, he now get the ball down the right-hand side. Ollie Johnson chasing. Wins it. He's into the box. Goalkeeper to beat. Goes past him. Shoots. Just wide. Takes a deflection. It's gone behind for a corner. But Ollie Johnson did so well there down the left-hand side. Robbed the fullback. Got into the box. Pulled across the face of the goal. Managed to get an angle to shoot. But it was just deflected wide corner to Guiseley.
I can see why he kept on going to get the shot off. But he should have squared that to Anthony Dudley, who was in a few yards of space. Had the easier job to just put it in.
So Boreham Wood are leading. Halifax still scoreless. Guiseley 3-0 up. And now with a corner on the right-hand side. Floats into the box towards a penalty spot. Headed away. Free kicks given against Adam Boyd. The referee thought there was maybe some form of knock on the tussle between the two defenders, or the defender and the attacker, as they went to try and win the ball. It's a moment there, these red herrings of score lines. In the old day, we all used to be tuned into our transistor radios. That was the final day of the season story. Everyone's tuned into transistor radios. They were pressed against the ear, listening to see whatever radio scores you could pick up. Now it's all Twitter and YouTube, as you're following us. And sometimes the information can be a little misleading.
Yeah, in the case of the app that we use on a regular basis.
Ajala now on the ball for Torquay as he's skipped past Jake Lawley. He's making some good headway down the right side. Ball into the box, claimed by Stephen Drench. 10 minutes to go to the break. Guys, 3 goals to the good. Ollie Johnson got us underway. Will Hatfield with the second, and Anthony Dudley a sublime finish for the third. And we might have had more. The truth of the matter is we might well have had more. Anthony Dudley's already hit the woodwork. And Ollie Johnson denied by a last-ditch deflection a few moments ago.
Well, we may have just thought that Macclesfield had taken the lead against us, but it's consolation. They have just followed us on Twitter. They have just followed Guiseley on Twitter.
Anthony Dudley.
Where have you been all season, Macclesfield?
Yeah, I feel a bit hard done by. I'm sure we'll follow them. Hatfield now on the ball. Played down the right-hand side. Boys chases. It's a big one for Gehring to win that battle. He does, and it's knocked out for a Guiseley throw, though. Adam Boys not giving up that chase whatsoever. And a throw from the right-hand side. And it's a chance here for Ryan Toulson to loft this one long. He's back to the hoardings, pointing and directing Guiseley to get further into the 18-yard box. Lofted in by Toulson. Good throw, but it's headed away. Picked up now by Jake Lawler, battling ever so hard. Helped away. Bounces up on the centre circle. Rob Atkinson up against Harrod. Harrod thinks he's merits a free kick for the challenge, but referee doesn't agree. Headed away now by Torquay. Once again, picked up by Ajala inside the centre circle. Toby Ajala goes down the left-hand side with some purpose now. Torquay coming forward. Ajala goes for the return ball. Skips it past Atkinson, goes in towards the touchline. Can he cross? He can, but it's blocked well by Hatfield, who works ever so hard to get back, and that's conceding a corner. I think that's going to be Torquay's first corner of this game.
Yeah, and another chance to get the likes of Exus Geoghegan up from the back to try and cause Guiseley a few problems.
3-0, but a corner now to Torquay. 3-0 to Guiseley. This one's whipped in, claimed by Stephen Drench in the six-yard box, and is immediately looking to get Anthony Dudley into the action. Upfield, the ball headed down, picked up now by Boys. Boys has got Ajala on him. Boys has to go back, does well actually to hold on to possession. The temptation might have been to go forward. Low with a great crossfield ball. Finds Smith on the edge of the 18-yard box. Smith tries to float it again. A little bit showboaty. Tries to float it over the goalkeeper there, Moore, and in the end, it's over the crossbar and behind for a goal kick.
Well, I was going to try and be kind then and say he was looking to find somebody at the back post, but if I'm completely honest, I think you're right. I think he was trying to lift it over the top of the keeper in towards the far post. Options were getting up in support. Not quickly enough, though, as far as Adam Smith was concerned.
Blissett now on the ball. Oh, he lobs the ball over Hatfield, running through towards the edge of the 18-yard box. Helped away by Atkinson, but only as far as Cheney. Cheney's shot from distance. Comfortable for Drench. And the Lions, again, just need to take a breather. It's been frenetic pace, hasn't it? And it must take its toll on these players over the course of the 90. Header away now from Gehring again. The centre-half only manages to find the head of Toulson. Flicked on by Boys, and Holly Johnson's found to be offside. He must have been returning marginally offside there. But the flag on that far side.
Yeah, there can't have been a great deal in that.
No complaint. You can tell, actually, can't you? When Mark Cunliffe's flag goes up, there's no complaints from behind the fans behind him. He's probably got that right. 6 minutes to go to the break.
I keep
looking at my watch. Yeah. How long's got? 39. It feels like 95. Feels like I'm 95. I believe I look it. Torquay now on the ball inside the Lions half. Good interception from Hatfield. And ever such hard work from Ollie Johnson again. He's been a real hero today. Plays the ball down the right-hand side and it rolls all the way through to the goalkeeper, Brendan Moore. It's still chance now for Torquay to press the ball forward. Up in the air now, Guiseley win it with Hatfield, who actually gets the rub of the green on that occasion because it bounces up against Blissett's arm, and a handball is given by referee today against Nathan Blissett. Will be a free kick to Guiseley.
Yeah, certainly struck the arm of Blissett. Stephen Drench again will take this free kick.
Whilst those other games are as they are, it's ever so nerve-wracking, isn't it? The ball's played forward, headed away now by Verma. There's a little bit of awkward play from both sides as they both struggle to get control of the ball. Smith now on it on the right flank. Cuts in field, shows some good trickery. Plays a lovely reverse pass here to Norburn. Ollie Johnson. Ollie Johnson on the right-hand flank. gets the ball into the box, up towards the edge of the 6-yard box, headed on by Dudley, blocked by the Torquay defence. And now Dudley, who's battling hard against Verma, and he's struggling to get through. Hatfield is tackled by Ajala, and is a chance for a counter-attack for Torquay. This time the ball played right out of play by Luke Young. Torquay looking a little dysfunctional here.
It was a wonderful pass to Matt Bauer.
That'll do. Guiseley.
Couple of goals elsewhere. Cheltenham have taken the lead against Lincoln, and Kidderminster have taken the lead at Southport. They lead by 2-1.
Ollie Johnson can't keep the ball in play. Nice little bit of trickery to try and play in Ryan Tulson. I do feel it's important, actually, that we don't let Torquay get in this next 3 minutes a foothold back in this game.
Yeah, absolutely. We've got to go in as it is at the very least, if not better. Well, to be fair, we can't really whinge at 3-0 up at half-time, but
we can't
it's
whinge.
Important not to let them back in and to not give them that foothold.
Counter-attacks on, Atkinson intercepts. Balls away, up towards Adam Boys. Roll out to the goalkeeper, Brendan Moore. He plays it long, over the head of Jake Lawler. Again, Rob Atkinson reacting first, scooping the ball out of play. Another throw right into the fourth official's box. It's taken quickly and down the right-hand side, and it's picked up here by Torquay. And it's a good play from Richards, who keeps the ball ticking over for the visitors. Out to the left-hand side, Butler. On towards Cheney. Sam Cheney is tackled by Ryan Tulson. It's going to be a throw into Guiseley. It takes a deflection off Sam Cheney, who's spent time out on loan this season for Torquay. He's been with Biddeford. Obviously a prospect they're wanting to develop. And, he's trying to put an impression onto this game, but Torquay so far failed to do so. As Guiseley lead by 3-0 with 2 minutes to go before the break. Johagen forced to nod the ball back to the goalkeeper, Brendan Moore. Another goal for us in the important games. Tell us about it, Chris.
Well, it's Boreham Wood. They've doubled their lead at Welling. They lead by 2-0 at Parkview Road. So and as things stand, all hope is on Halifax dropping points.
And there's another one, I think, just coming through.
Braintree have doubled their lead at home to Altrincham.
So one result's partially good. It's not really all that important now, as long as we win our game with Altrincham. It's Boreham Wood and Halifax, so it's all down to Macclesfield.
Comes come on,
down
the silver
to Macclesfield. I've always loved Macclesfield. I had a lovely weekend there, by the way. Stopped out of town. It was a beautiful place. I love Macclesfield. I bumped into an old mate from university who happened to be sat in one seat in front of us.
Hopefully.
Always like Macclesfield.
Hopefully you'll be able to pay my visit there next season.
Yeah.
Come on, the silt man.
Now, ball back underway as we wrap it on. Danny Lowe picks up the ball on the halfway line. Chips it down the left-hand side again. Headed up and away by Verma, but into the body of Dudley. Falls kindly for Verma on the second occasion. Again, as the half-time 45 is up. The ball has gone out of play. And again, Guiseley's pressure is telling in the final third, which isn't something we've said much this season. 3 minutes of added time now, and Danny Lowe will loft this one into the box. As they trundle in. I'm not quite sure. Is it 3 minutes, did you hear, for added time? 3 minutes?
I completely missed that.
Not quite sure what the added time is. We'll just have
to... It was two or three, we think.
It's into the Torquay area, and once again, Johagen has just lofted the ball out of play.
As long as the ball stays down that end for it, I'm happy.
Yeah, exactly. Could be important. 1-0. 3-0, sorry, to Guiseley. 2-0 to Boreham Wood. 0-0 so far in the game between Macclesfield and Halifax. Guiseley now pressing, but conceding a free kick against Ajala. And a free kick that will be played in right back position.
Oh,
A minute and 15 seconds into stoppage time.
I feel a bit ill, if I'm completely honest.
Yeah, I know. Ball goes forward. It's chested down. Oh, and a free kick has been given against Jake Lawler. Against Nathan Blissett. And that is in a dangerous position. It was just a punt forward. Lawler's protesting. He's not happy at all with that decision. And I must admit, it's not. Didn't look like he had much of his hands around Blissett at all. But the referee has seen something. Free kick it is to Torquay. Very dangerous position. It's these sort of things that could be just changing moments, game-changing moments. We have to be very wary of these last moments here in this first half. Free kick to Torquay. And it's a long ranger. There's four-man wall just on the edge of the D. It's very central. Stephen Drench just organising the positions and the shapes. This one's going to be taken. Butler goes over, drills a very good one in, but it's well held by Stephen Drench. The goalkeeper holds on to it, and that's the last action of a first half. And just listen to the response from the home crowd there. Absolutely delighted with the effort and the endeavour that has been shown by this Guiseley side that have raced into a three-goal lead. Ollie Johnson after 4 minutes. Will Hatfield, a simple tap in after 10. Brilliant work from Adam Boysen set up at that goal. And Anthony Dudley on the half hour have given Guiseley a thumping three-goal cushion in at the break. But it doesn't rest on us anymore. It's all down to what happens at the other games. And what happens there is crucial in determining whether the Lions step up. But the real positive is that Guiseley are doing their business, and we can ask no more than that from this afternoon.
Absolutely. A really good half from the Lions there. Three different goal scorers on the score sheet as well. But you kind of think, where's this been? Where has this level of performance been? We haven't seen it too often. It came out against Wrexham and then just disappeared, and it's come back in full effect now. But as it is, we are relying on scores elsewhere. Dave Kendra is alongside us now. Dave, let's just start with how are your nerves from that. Oh no, Halifax have scored. Halifax have got a late goal in the end of the first half.
2 minutes into stoppage time at the end of the game at the Shea. Halifax have taken the lead against Macclesfield, and along with Boreham Wood currently winning 2-0 against Welling, I'm afraid it means that this afternoon may yet turn on a sixpence against the Lions. But Chris, let's just try and concentrate on what's gone on here this afternoon. 3-0 up. A magnificent first half performance from the Lions.
Yeah, we've been absolutely fantastic, you know. As I say, it really does make you wonder sometimes, where has this level of performance been? You know, where was this against in recent games? You know, last week, for example, at Boreham Wood and away at Macclesfield and in games early this season. But, you know, we were doing exactly what we asked of them at the start of the afternoon, in terms of our part at least. We wanted a performance, we wanted chances, we wanted goals. We've got what we wanted from our side.
Yeah.
We've just got to hope that things change in the second half and that we can keep this up.
So, well, we're looking for a second half turnaround from either Welling, our friends at Welling or Macclesfield. For them, Halifax currently leading 1-0 in that game. Boreham Wood winning 2-0 away at Welling. Altrincham are losing 2-0. Away at Braintree, so that's Braintree definitely into the promotion playoff picture. Well, it is what it is, isn't it? It's as we've said, Guiseley are doing their bit though, and there is a lot to be hopeful for. You know, there is still a lot of football to be played. 45 minutes yet. Just try and pick out some individual performances from that first half, there, Chris.
Ollie Johnson, brilliant. He's had a really good game. He's looked lively. And Adam Smith for me as well. You know, don't get me wrong, a couple of occasions he's tried to do too much. But to be fair, that's the fact, you know, it's enthusiasm. He's back on the football patch. He wants things to happen for him. You know, he hasn't started a game since Altrincham away, so you can't blame him for being keen and wanting to get a goal and try things. But for me in particular, those two. And of course, Will Hatfield as well, the second goal scorer for the Lions. Who's putting the kind of shift that we come to expect of him by now.
Yeah, certainly Hatfield's putting a shift. Johnson's putting a shift. Boys has done well as well. creating all sorts of problems. And I think Adam Smith as well has had a pretty decent game. To say he's not played for the last few games, it's hard to pick out. It's almost impossible to pick out a duff performance from the Lions in that first half. So I mean, really, they've been sent out with a mission to win this game, and they're halfway there. They've done everything that they needed to do. And if it is to be the last day in the Vanarama National League, they've done themselves proud. So it's half time here at Nethermore, and as Nick Keith tweeted us at Guiseley Radio, it looks like it's the hope that's going to kill us. We're also joined this afternoon by Yorkshire Radio's Tom Feeney. Tom, you saw that first half, elated as the players walked off the pitch, and then the news broke from De Shea.
Yeah, I mean, and you know, obviously, I think the Halifax players will have been told what was happening with Guiseley, and you know, by the sounds of it, they've had a couple of chances in the first half, and you know, they've taken the lead. And in all fairness, by the looks of it, you know, on social media, it looks like it's fair that they've had the better chances in that game. But for Guiseley, it's, you know, just all about maintaining what happens in the second half, keeping up this level of performance, and you know, just making sure that the likes of Halifax and Borough have to get something from their games. And hopefully, you know, fingers crossed, something can happen somewhere. And I'm feeling a bit like I was a year ago at Chorley right now. I really am. But we saw what happened that time. Let's see if it can happen again.
Hang on, because the team leading at half time in that game ended up losing. Let's hope that doesn't happen. But there is applause around Nethermore at the moment for the Benton Park Schoolboys, who won the English Schools Cup in midweek. They won it on penalties. They took the lead 3-1 and were pegged back in the last moments there, but then went on to take the trophy on penalties, and now walking around Nethermore parading the cup that they've won. We congratulate Benton Park for their efforts. Well done there. We're also joined this afternoon by members of the winning FA Vars team of 1991, and we've also signed the Army Covenant this afternoon, ensuring that Guiseley Radio is a full supporter of our armed forces. Chris, you have something to tell us.
I was just going to say, shall I go through the half-time scores of Everywhere?
Chris, take us through the half-time scores of Everywhere. We might as well. Let's do it. Let's round this off this season. Go on.
So half-times across the Vanarama National League: Barrow 1, Wrexham 0, Braintree 2, Altrincham 0, Bromley 1, Aldershot 1, Cheltenham 1, Lincoln City 1. The Imps getting a late equaliser in stoppage time there at the end of the first half. Chester 0, Gateshead 0. It's 0-0 between Dover and Forest Green. Guiseley 3, Torquay United 0, FC Halifax 1, Macclesfield 0, Southport 1, Kidderminster Harriers 2, Tranmere Rovers 1, Grimsby 0, Welling 0, Borehamwood 2, and Woking 2, Eastleigh 0.
Now, I don't normally let you do this, but we might as well on this last day, looking at it, going up from the bottom. Welling on the bottom on 35, Kidderminster, who are winning 2-1, by the way, one last hurrah for them. They're on 40 points in 23rd place, 22nd Altrincham on 44, Guiseley in 21st on 49. Halifax and Boreham Wood both on 50 would be safe, and Torquay in 18th are already safe on 51. That is only half time. There is still 45 minutes, and we must still cling on to that. We must still cling on that there is still hope. 1-0 leads can be turned around all the time. Macclesfield are a decent side. They'll not want to end the season on a defeat. There's pride to play for there. Halifax can concede goals. They do concede goals. We've seen it. Games can turn around at half time. There's still hope here, isn't there, Chris?
Yes, I think.
And all the Lions can do here, all they can do is hang on to this lead, maybe extend it in the second half, make sure they, like Tom says, make sure they come away with those 3 points, and make sure that Halifax and Boreham Wood absolutely have to get something.
Yeah, I mean, that's to say, we've seen a fantastic first half performance from Guiseley, and for the second half, it needs to be very much the same. I mean, to be fair, you'd be unfortunate as a side to win in the way that we are at the moment. Excuse me. If we could do that over full time, over the 90 minutes and come out at full time with a win of substantial margin to then go down, it would be very, very unfortunate. But as it is, that's how things are. But as you say,
you know, Welling don't like Boreham Wood. They've still got a new manager that they're playing for. I'm fairly sure he's got a few choice words for them. And of course, as you say, Macclesfield, they're a good side. They're an organised side. Halifax can see goals. There's still some hope there.
Well, with the greatest of respect to Welling, and we like our friends at Welling United, and they were very nice to us when we went down there. They made us gravy.
On the
opening day of the season. Of gravy of sorts, it's half a cup of Bovril. But it was the effort that we appreciated, so yeah. We'll be sad to see them.
We'd love to appreciate that effort for the second half.
But I think if there is hope this afternoon, it probably lies with the Siltman, it probably lies with Macclesfield.
Absolutely. In fact, can we get the guys the radio cap? Can we tweet Macclesfield, yeah? Can we do this?
It was suggested.
Come on, you Siltman.
It was suggested to me in that first half that this game's won now. We might as well get on a coach and get to the Shea for the second half. Support Macclesfield on. It's a bit extreme. Talking of the crowd this afternoon, it's a fantastic attendance. We exhausted people to come out this afternoon to support the side, and they have responded in the best possible way. The attendance this afternoon, 1,915 people here.
Crikey.
At Nethermore this afternoon. And at the moment, they're being treated to a tremendous performance from the Lions, and 303 hardy travellers from Torquay have made their way up as well.
Yeah, that's superb, isn't it, for the fact that, you know, we haven't really peaked. I mean, that works out at 1,600 fans here for Guiseley. Where have you been? But thanks for coming.
Well, thank you for
Where
coming
have you been,
this
but
afternoon.
Thanks for coming.
Right, you and me need to take a break. We need to take a breath. And we need to compose ourselves, because there's a whole 45 minutes worth of football. We, of course, took a long trip earlier in the season down to the Torquay Riviera, and we covered that game earlier in the season, and these are the highlights from that game.
Referee blows his whistle, and away we go. Toulson on the right-hand side, floats the ball in towards the edge of the 18-yard box, all the way through to Boys. Boys back to goal, gives it to Dickinson. He shoots, blocked by Gio Hagen, behind for a Guiseley corner from the right-hand side. Thompson will deliver, plays it in towards the 6-yard box. Lawler, great header, great save there from space. And Guiseley come very close to breaking the deadlock. Jake Lawler with a header. Spies with the fine reactions inside the Torquay goal. Corner to Guiseley.
Terrific save that from Fabian Spies.
Thompson will take. Lawler's in there again. It's in towards the penalty spot. Headed away this time. Brooksby keeps the ball in the area, and he's bundled over when he goes to win the ball on the edge of the D. And it was Simon Heslop who crunched into him. And Guiseley have a free kick. And Matt Bauer, you can hear down below, screaming instructions to the Lions. And they will have a free kick in a dangerous position. Peels off and joins the edge of the wall. Thompson takes, curls this one in. Off the crossbar. And Guiseley almost break the deadlock again. The ball back in there, in towards Boys. Dickinson inside the 6-yard box. The ball's behind for a corner. But what an effort that was from Zach Thompson. Curled the ball in, hit the upright. And Guiseley just couldn't quite force the ball over the line.
Yeah, that was a stunning free kick from Zach Thompson.
Looking to get some aerial threat onto this one. Curled in by Thompson. This time he goes for goal. Oh, it's just past the upright again. Still 0-0 here. Wayne Brooksby heads on the halfway line. Played into Liam Dickinson. Great ball in here to Adam Boyce. Clear of the back line. Boyce shoots the ball over the bar. Oh, he should have done better with that one. It was a lovely touch from Liam Dickinson that sent the ball through. Adam Boyes timed his run to perfection, but he tried to take the ball on the volley, the half volley at the first attempt, and in the end he has fired it high and over the bar and into the fans behind that goal. Tackled, but Guiseley win possession back here. Toulson, though, he's robbed by Lavelle Moore. Lavelle Moore now goes down this left-hand side up against Will Hatfield. Referee doesn't intercept on that occasion. The ball to the left-hand side played in, and there's a ball straight across the face of the 6-yard box that Alex Fisher was stretching to try and get on the end.
Well, we'll just interrupt those highlights because, of course, we're now back underway. We're about to get underway, rather, here at Nethermore for the second 45. A brilliant first 45 minutes from the Lions. 3-0 up, and they've hit the woodwork as well. It could genuinely have been more, but, and this is the big but, just on the stroke of half-time, Halifax scored at home to Macclesfield, and as it stands, the Lions would be relegated this evening should the scores stay the same. Halifax 1-0 up, Boreham Wood 2-0 up at Welling, Lions 3-0 up here against Torquay. And we're back underway. Toulson heading on to Jake Lawler. The ball knocked out as Torquay, who will no doubt respond some way to that first half performance. The goals not convincing in that first 45, but equally Guiseley absolutely superb in that first 45. And Ajala on the ball now for Torquay, and it's it through, and it's a chance here for Richards to take a shot at goal from the edge of the 18-yard box, and it's gone wide for a goal kick.
And already Torquay have been lively in trying to get bodies forward so they can try and get away back in. Really good following, 303 from the south coast on what is a 1,900 plus attendance here at Nethermore.
But it's flattened, hasn't it, since the news of that goal came through for Halifax. We just have to watch the other scorelines this afternoon as much as watch this game. Smith now on the counter-attack for Guiseley, bringing the ball into the Torquay half for the first time in the second half. Smith on the right flank, going to be held up. The cross goes in, and it's knocked out for a Guiseley throw. Just up from the corner flag on that right-hand side.
Yeah, Dan Butler did well. Stayed strong as Smith tried to get the cross in.
Guiseley not giving up, chasing another goal. The ball here with Ollie Johnson on the right flank. Gives it here to Hatfield. Hatfield's cross into the box. Helped away, though, as Torquay repel that attack. Only as far as Atkinson. Rob Atkinson ships the ball high in the air. It's headed away. Picked up now by Lawler, who chips it down the left-hand side. Helped away again that time by Verma. The fullback sends it long, and Guiseley now playing into the sun defensively, having some difficulty perhaps seeing the ball high in the air. Torquay have picked up the ball now with Blissett. He lays it to the left-hand side, finds Butler, the fullback, plays the ball into the area. Chested down, chance here for Cheney to get on the end of it. Intercepted well by Toulson. Only as far, though, as Richards. And then a free kick is given to Guiseley midway through the Lions' half. A chance to slow it down. But this low sun could be a problem this evening, couldn't it, for the Lions in this second period?
Yeah, absolutely. As I expected before kick-off, Stephen Drench has got his Guiseley cap out for the second half.
Well, the Lions will take this free kick. And Drench will launch the ball forward. Headed away by Gierhagen. And has another bite of the cherry as Jake Lawler nods it back to him. Now Boys is on the ball, plays it to the left-hand side. Dudley on the run, cuts infield. Super tackle on him, though. Brilliant tackle from Verma, who plays the ball forward. Headed into the head of Blissett, who can't quite follow the ball in the sun himself, but does keep possession with the visitors. Cheney now to Butler, down the left side. Blissett chasing. Atkinson gets it back to Drench, who in turns clears, but not very convincingly. Young is the recipient of the ball, but well, Hatfield wins it back off Young and then gives it to Toulson. Toulson sends it long up towards Boys. Gehring steps across, though, and ensures it rolls through to Gierhagen. Still Guiseley lead by 3-0 as we kick off the second half, knowing that with the results elsewhere as they stand, it won't be enough. We'll keep you up to speed with all those goals, all those potential changing moments that there might be in the second half, and we certainly hope there are some. Just not here. Now Ben Parker's lost out, and lost out to Sean Harrod, who gets the ball into the area, onto the edge of the 18-yard box. Torquay press now as they look to get a foothold back in this game. Little back heel trying to pick out Cheney. But it doesn't work well for Ajala. Guiseley managed to clear, but again, they're camped in their own half at the moment. Torquay now beginning to turn the screw a little bit in this game for the first time. They're enjoying prolonged spells of possession in the Lions' half. Onto the edge of the 18-yard box, a spin from Cheney. But Guiseley recover the ball, and it's with Smith. Smith running down the right-hand side now. So a long time out of the game as he has come back from injury. But he runs the ball out of play. Butler picks possession back up for Guiseley. Boys closing down Gehring as much as he can, and also closing down the goalkeeper, forcing his low clearance into the pathway of Jake Lawler. But Torquay recover possession. Hatfield scurrying around, trying to win the ball back for Guiseley, but it's eventually found its way through to the Guiseley penalty area, but fortunately all the way through to Stephen Drench.
I keep refreshing the scores and refreshing Twitter and hoping to see something. It does seem that they're a few minutes behind us at the Shea.
Guys, he's on the attack now. Smith has picked up the ball. He closes in, goes across the face of goal. And it goes into the Torquay defence, who can then in turn counter-attack here with Butler. And Butler plays it infield here to Ajala. Ajala, nice movement now from Torquay as they look to counter-attack. Play it out to the left-hand side, and Butler plays the ball into the box. It's awkward for Stephen Drench. A lunge towards goal from Harrod. It's defended well by Danny Lowe, and the referee in the end decides that that took the last touch of Harrod and goes behind for a goal kick. And we're going to see Torquay's first change of the afternoon as well.
We are indeed, and it's going to be Danny Rackey, I think, is the man who's coming on, and he is replacing Sam Chaney. So the man who, as I touched on earlier, was on trial here with the Lions in pre-season last summer, is going to come on against us this afternoon.
Well, Rackey was playing in that game friendly against Dorset. That was the only friendly actually I managed to take in the summer, thanks to holidays. But sort of a solid holding midfielder role he played that day. Guiseley now having to do a bit of defending here because Atkinson's under pressure once again. And again, this pendulum with Torquay in this game just for the moment. Ben Parker now under pressure from Ajala. Does well to prevent it going for a corner. Only knocks it out for a throw-in for Torquay. Torquay take the throw. Taking the ball into the box as well from Verma. A header into the back of the net. And it's Blissett who's got one back for the goals. And Guiseley have a huge moment here. Stephen Drench is trying to hold on to the ball there for a moment. The referee comes to separate him from Harrod. But that could be a big goal this afternoon. Guiseley 3, Torquay 1.
Well, it's come at a really bad time, hasn't it, as well? Early in this second half, and Torquay have got a goal back and they've given their fans something to shout about.
Free kick, kick-off rather now. I'm not quite sure what that cheer was for. But Guiseley now need to raise the tempo, raise the bar again in the second half. 3 points essential.
It's almost like knowing scores elsewhere. The heads have dropped almost in the early stages for the Lions players.
Toulson's now on the right-hand side. He plays it square now to Smith. Smith into the feet of Jake Lawler, but Lawler's beaten to it well by Richards. But Guiseley win the ball back here with Hatfield. Hatfield having a run forward now across the face of this Torquay back line. Plays it out to the left flank. Danny Lowe now for Guiseley. Plays it towards the edge of the 18-yard box. Dudley runs away with it. Goes back away from goal to keep hold of possession under tremendous pressure. Then Guiseley can't keep it in play. And it's out for a throw into Torquay. And that confidence factor just begins to play into the minds again, doesn't it? Once again, when we're on our game, we're absolutely superb. Like Wrexham. Like that first half. But when we lose it, I just wonder whether we've got enough character to battle through.
Yeah, well, as I say, for me, the heads seem to have dropped even before the Torquay goal.
Ball's now gone towards Blissett again, who seems to have been renewed by that goal, forcing Ben Parker to launch the ball out for another Torquay throw.
Guiseley just not looking comfortable, are we at all? There's still, as you say, a long way to go.
These long throws of Exodus Yehagen as well were a feature in the return fixture, and he's got another chance to launch one into the box in towards Blissett, headed away by Jake Lawler. And out again for another throw for Yehagen to loft back into the box. As good as a corner, headed away by Danny Lowe. Headed away again by Ollie Johnson. Picked up by Adam Boys, who plays a lovely ball into the pathway of Smith. Smith helps it on for Hatfield over the halfway line. Hatfield up against Rackey, goes backwards. Gives it to Toulson. Toulson keeps the ball ticking over, finds Jake Lawler. Ball bobbles awkwardly for Jake Lawler. Controls though well, gives it to Ollie Johnson. Ollie Johnson spins on the ball, wants to give it through to Utley Dudley. Tries to play it with the outside of the foot in towards Dudley. It was a right idea, but just anticipated at the right time by Ajala. And the ball all the way back to Stephen Drench. Guiseley now get the ball returned into that Torquay half as they seem to need to set about this Torquay United defence once again. And involve their key men. Ollie Johnson And Anthony Dudley this afternoon been superb when they've been on the ball. And again, good football from the Lions. Toulson steps forward into Smith. Smith and Toulson combine well. Out to the right-hand side. Oh, it's intercepted at the critical time before Smith can get through clear on the right-hand flank. And it's picked up now by Harrod on the halfway line. Floats the ball out to the right. Up in the air now, rather awkwardly from Ajala. Picked up now by Ollie Johnson. Inside his own half. Good tackle comes in on him by Ajala. And it's square now to Young. Young out here to Butler on the left-hand side. Three to aim for Butler. He crosses into the box, in towards Splissett, headed away by Ben Parker. Picked up by Racky. Guiseley now having to set the defensive line, but Ollie Johnson sticks to his task, closes down Danny Racky, and it's out for a throw.
Couple of goals from elsewhere. Chester 0, Gateshead 1, and Dover 0, Forest Green 1.
Ball in towards the edge of the 18-yard box by Butler. And then it's defended clear, and it's got away here. Adam Boys clean through on the right-hand side. Still a lot to do. Exodus Juhagen with him. Boys crosses, held by the keeper. He was going down towards the byline, wanted to pull it back maybe to find Ollie Johnson or Anthony Dudley. They couldn't get there quite in time, and in the end, Boys simply gave it back to the goalkeeper.
Yeah, really good chance as well for Guiseley. One of few real attacks from the Lions in this second half.
The ball now with Ajala. Ajala to the right-hand side and to the feet of Racky. Danny Racky plays it towards the edge of the 18-yard box. But Torquay still win possession back. Racky square now. Finds Young. Young threads the ball through, but it's going to go all the way through to Stephen Drench. Nervy, nervy, nervy Nethermore. Now it's still 3-1. Thanks to Phil Morecambe. It could be 10-9 as long as other results go the right way. It's the hope that hurts.
You're not kidding, are you, Phil?
Not kidding. Tentative moment there for Torquay because the ball played back. And now guys have robbed it again with Ollie Johnson doing ever so well into the box. But he's got a lot of work to do and he can't keep it in play. And it rolls out for a goal kick. But good work there from both Anthony Dudley and Ollie Johnson. But I feel we need to step up a little bit and force the play into their half.
Yeah, absolutely. Look at that's what we did in the first half, and it's what up until the last minute or two we've been really lacking this second half. We need to get ourselves back on the front foot because Torquay have got that goal, they've got that foot all back in the game, their heads are up and they're looking confident. We need to get back at them, get in the faces and look to attack and build on what we've already got.
58 minutes gone. Guiseley 3, Torquay 1. But that's not the full story because it's also Welling 0, Boreham Wood 2. And Halifax 1, Macclesfield 0. Which means Guiseley would be relegated as it stands. The ball cleared now from Guiseley as Torquay come forward. Ollie Johnson on the halfway line. Exodus Juhagen doing well to close him down. I'll give him a moment's pace. He goes back to Danny Lowe. Danny Lowe sends it down the left-hand channel. And just for the moment, the Lions not looking in the same have the same verve and the same ability to hold on to the ball as they did in the first. So we expect it to come back. They're challenged against this low sun that they're playing into now, Guiseley. And the ball forward finds Harrod, but it's well defended by Danny Lowe. But then he runs out of space, bemoans the fact that around him he didn't get any support. And now it's a throw-in for Juhagen to launch into the box once again. You just feel if Torquay were to get this second, it would become very nervy here as well. Juhagen just up from the corner flag on the right-hand side. Plenty to aim for. Lofts this one in. Headed on in the box. It's loose. Ajala goes. He knocks it home. Goal to Torquay. And it's now a second for the goals. And Guiseley have conceded once again a scrappy goal from a set piece. And it's Torquay United who now, having been 3-0 down at half-time, have the momentum. And it's now Guiseley 3, Torquay 2.
And there's still half an hour to go. Guiseley are doing their best at the moment to throw away what hope we had. They've not sorted themselves out in this second half at all. They've looked shaky from set pieces. And again, that the ball just dropped in the box, scrambled around a bit, and was just stamped home by a yellow shirt.
Butler now on the ball. Guys, he just at seconds to the races at the moment. Butler on the left-hand side. Lawler and Toulson doubling up on him, winning the ball off him. This was a man who could hardly get forward and out of his own half in the first 45. It's up, headed on by Gehring, back in towards the edge of the 18-yard box. Torquay almost working their way through, helped away by Ben Parker, taken down by Boys. Boys takes a pass, Gehring. He's clipped by Gehring. Boys is furious. Surely it's going to be a yellow card for the Torquay centre-half. Well, took one for the team there, surely, Ben Gehring.
Yeah, I think it probably will be. The referee's going to call him over anyway, and we'll have a word and we'll see where it goes from there. But as it is, we've still got 29 minutes left, and Guiseley just... Oh, it's stark contrast to the first half. It really is. Whatever Kevin Nicholson said, though, the Torquay United boss, whatever he said at half-time, it sure worked for Torquay. They've come out with a much better attitude about it, and they've got themselves... What a goal just to go behind inside the first 15 minutes. But from Guiseley's perspective, that's very, very worrying.
Ball goes forward. It's nodded out and behind. It's going to be a Guiseley corner now. A free kick was a decent delivery from Rob Atkins inside his own half. But really, it shouldn't have resulted in the corner. It has for Guiseley. It could really do with restoring a two-goal cushion here. Adam Smith will go across to take this from the left-hand side. The Lions get bodies into the box. 3-2 now to Guiseley. Smith plays the ball into the box over Blissett, who was back there defending and headed away. Well recovered by Hatfield. It goes down the left-hand side, but again, it's Racky this time who's there to clear for Torquay. Still the Lions in the last relegation spot as it stands. Winning 3-2. Borehamwood 2-0 up against Welling. Halifax 1-0 up at home to Macclesfield.
I think we're going to see Gavin Rothery fairly soon for Guiseley.
Free kick's been given to Torquay in right back position. He is indeed stripped off and ready to come on.
And it's Ollie Johnson. It's Ollie Johnson who's coming off. Injury, a knock, or just tactical, but surely not.
Well, Ollie Johnson did such a lot of work over that 60 minutes, but I just think he's possibly only got an hour's worth of football in him at the moment.
Yeah.
And Gavin Rothery, who's been a real talisman over the years for Guiseley, he's going to play in the centre of the three. Dudley onto the left, Smith on the right. Ball goes forward anyway, and Torquay counter-attack here with Harrod on the right-hand side. Ajala, again, they're finding spaces that they weren't in the first half. Ajala gets it into the box. A lunging clearance from Ben Parker. It goes behind for a corner, but uncertain defending once again from Nervy Guiseley. There's news coming through of a huge goal. We've got a corner. Quickly tell us it, Chris.
It looks like Macclesfield have equalised at the Shea.
Well, I'm doing commentary, but really I want to scream out, come on, Guiseley, to be honest. This is such an important moment. Corner comes in, headed away by Boys. Guiseley have got to defend it. It's not. Gehring gets it back in there. Dudley clears. One each at the moment between Halifax and Macclesfield. Guiseley can cling on to this lead. If that score stays like that, the Lions would stay up. Gio Hagen, though, wants to turn that round. He's got a throw on this right-hand side, and they're going to loft bodies forward again to get back into level terms. 3-2. Ball launched into the box, headed away by Danny Lowe, but only as far as Racky. Racky picks it up on the right-hand side. Guys, you need to get out of their area, but they're still set deep. Ball back in there. Header just wide from Ben Gehring. And a corner has been given. How on earth has a corner been given from that? Ben Gehring cleanly headed the ball past the post, but the corner has been given, and there's a knock as well to the guys, the man who went in for the challenge, but a corner again from Torquay.
Well, it is a goal at Macclesfield. This one hasn't been corrected. Sorry, a goal for Macclesfield at Halifax.
65 minutes gone. You can see how Torquay want to punt this ball into the six-yard box. This is absolutely horrendous watching as a Guiseley fan. They are doing so well from set pieces, causing so many problems. They've scored two. It's 3-2. Guiseley need to hold on to this lead.
Stephen Drench has got about a dozen players in front of him there.
It's whipped into the box. It goes right onto the crossbar and behind, and this time it's a goal kick. It was a really wicked curling cross from that left flank. In the end, it goes behind. And there's going to be another Torquay sub over on the far side.
We'll come to that, but I'd just like to point out that Radio Yorkshire's Tom Feeney just screamed in my ear then. He thought that was dropping in. There is going to be another change for Torquay United. Make it a defensive one, not an attacker. Who's that then?
Andre Wright.
Andre, oh great, a striker, that's what we need. It's a striker who's coming on to replace Toby Ajala. Winger off, striker on.
Aloney from West Bromwich Albion. A man of pedigree. Andre Wright enters the fray. Guiseley with work to do. A lot of work to do if they're going to see this game through under tremendous pressure. Ball over the top now. And Dudley's chasing, but Verma's going to get there first and shepherd it out for a Torquay throw. 3-2 to the Lions here. Torquay fighting back from 3-0 deficit at half-time and now looking like the team in the ascendancy. Guiseley have been encouraged, though. With 25 minutes to go, Halifax have let a lead slip at home to Macclesfield. It's now Halifax 1, Macclesfield 1. As it stands, we're out of the bottom four. But it could change at any moment. And this game hangs by a knife edge. As Hagen tries to just shepherd the ball back and gets it out of play. And now it's a goal kick. And Smith has gone to ground. Smith has gone to ground. Adam Smith is on the ground and I think he's properly hurt. He's got a problem. No, he hasn't. Maybe not. He's just leapt up. I wonder if it's a hamstring. Guys, you haven't cleared their lines very well at all here. Smith needs to make this challenge, but he's injured. He's not able to make it. Butler can, on the left-hand side, get the ball into the area. Butler stumbles over. It goes behind for a goal kick. Now, is Adam Smith injured? Did he go to ground? Did he feel a tweak? What do you think, Chris?
I don't know. He went down, but it was slightly comical. As soon as you said he's gone down, looks injured, he jumped back to his chapped to his feet. Well, it's certainly game, set, match at Parkview Lane. Welling 0, Boreham Wood 3. That seems to be the only certain thing at the moment, is that Boreham Wood will be in the National League next season. We are going to see a change for Guiseley. Emil Sinclair, there's a name we didn't think we'd see again this season. He's going to be the man to come on.
Yeah, Emil Sinclair's coming on. I think Adam Smith's afternoon is over. He's made an impact, hasn't he, though, in this game?
He has. He's looked keen and enthusiastic and hungry. You know, in the first half, there was a couple of occasions when we thought he's tried to do too much and overplayed it. But you can't knock him, because this is the first time he's been on a football pitch since altering away.
Well, I don't think that is the substitute that Mark Bauer wanted to make. Emil Sinclair got off for the bench. Adam Smith has gone down. Martin Stringfellow's come onto the pitch, done the substitute motion, and I wonder whether it will be Sinclair, because the the indication to me was that I don't think they were anticipating Adam Smith being the player that they wanted to replace, but it is indeed going to be Sinclair, so what do I know who is coming on? But I just got the impression from all of that might not have been planned.
Yeah, I'm not entirely sure it was at first, but with the injury to Adam Smith, Emil Sinclair comes on. You would be likely to think Adam Boys will pull out to this right-hand side now, where he has played. He's, don't get me wrong, he's not his best there. But it's going to be Emil Sinclair to lead the line up top. Adam Boys will pull out onto this right-hand side. And there is a man who needs to be full of running, which is not something you want for somebody that's just recovering from a hamstring injury. But Emil Sinclair has got a big job in this remaining 20 minutes or so.
Oh, for a season that would peter out peacefully. 20 minutes that will decide the fate of Guiseley's season now. And they're on the attack on that left-hand side. Gavin Rothery goes chasing for it, but he's not going to get there. And it's out for a throw. Guys will take the throw level with the six-yard box. There's not the urgency that there might have been earlier on in the game, as the Lions just look to break down Torquay's resurgence in this second half. With it 3-2. As we hit the 70th minute, the throw taken short. Rothery battling hard to keep the ball. Gets it back to Lowe. Cross towards the penalty spot, but it's beyond Emil Sinclair. Then comfortably cleared by Butler. Headed down by Toulson. Into the feet of Jake Lawler. Now Boys on the ball. keeps possession, finds Hatfield, he lets it run and then plays it down the left channel, but there's nobody there. Dudley keeps chasing, poor butt touch from Verma. Verma up against Dudley is forced to knock the ball out. It's taken a touch off Dudley over that far side. It wasn't apparent to us over this side of the ground. But it's going to be a Torquay throw, and they get it up to the halfway line. Ben Parker recovers possession, finds Gavin Rothery. Into Dudley. Good ball in there. Sinclair goes chasing, but the goalkeeper swiftly off his line. Brendan Moore. Still 3-2.
If you're Mark Bauer, how do you see this game out as it is? Do we look to attack?
We need a fourth, I think.
Yeah. Oh,
that Will Hatfield's just picked up the ball and Danny Rackie has just tugged at him. Now, if that's not a yellow card, what is? Hatfield was through. But referee's not going to take any further action.
Elsewhere, Southport 2, Kidderminster 2. Speaking of petering out.
I tell you what, my heart's in my mouth every time you say the words elsewhere. Here.
I didn't bring my thesaurus.
Rob Atkinson to take the free kick for Guiseley on the halfway line. He punts it up towards the edge of the 18-yard box. Jake Lawler's held up by Verma. Verma does ever so well, actually. Free kick's been given to Torquay for some reason, but no dissent or disputing it from the Guiseley players. On the edge of the 18-yard box, shipped forward by Moore. Oh, it's well touched to Young, but his touch in turn is poor. And then Boyes plays the ball into the wrong place for Sinclair. Frustration between the two. The ball's gone over the top now. And that seems to be a dangerous thing to happen in this game in the half that Guiseley are currently defending with the low sun. But Guiseley managed to defend, but again, not really convincing in clearing their lines. Andre Wright tries to win, and then the end is adjudged to have fouled Danny Lowe. And the ball, as it was up in the air, I think he might have used a hand. And it's going to be a Guiseley throw. So with Altrincham trailing 3-0, Borehamwood winning 3-0 at Welling. Macclesfield and Halifax locked at one each. Guiseley winning 3-2. I do feel there's going to be one more change in those positions, isn't it? You feel there's going to be a scoreline shift. We've got to make sure we do our bit here.
Macclesfield hit the post. In
ball's inside the area and it's helped away by Butler. Now guys, you have to watch out because the counter attack could be on. It's picked up here by Boyes. Boyes threads it through. Dudley through a goal. 1-1. Dudley 4-2. Anthony Dudley has scored Guiseley's fourth this afternoon. Could that be the goal that keeps the Lions up? A super strike, cool finish. Guiseley 4, Torquay 2.
Anthony Dudley racing through, putting it beyond the keeper. 4-2 to the Lions. We just can keep this going. But it's completely and utterly still out of our hands. And that's my worry.
Huge, huge, huge 15 minutes now.
Especially considering Macclesfield have hit the post in that game. But they're also roughly 3 minutes behind us.
We're going to be listening in, aren't we, potentially?
We're going to still be here. We'll be looking across, no doubt, at our colleagues from BBC Radio Leeds.
The ball goes out wide, actually. Sorry, Chris, I just thought Torquay were mustering an attack. I beg your pardon, continue.
No, I was going to say, we'll be staying across at Nick and Kitter, who's here on summariser duty. Because they'll have all the links to Fletch, no doubt, over at the Shay.
Ball bounces off Adam Boyes. He can't keep it in play. He works ever so hard to do so. Out here on the right-hand side now, Boyes playing in the right midfield position. Crossfield ball as Torquay know that they should have been on the ascendancy, but have been pegged back now. 4-2 to Guiseley. Toulson clears, but so not a good clearance. It finds Butler. The ball in towards the edge of the 18-yard box. Harrod picks it up. Tackle comes in on him by Will Hatfield. Jake Lawler skips the ball past him. Herod goes down, feels his ankle for effect. It's cleared only as far as Jehagen. Jehagen keeps it down, plays it to the right-hand side. Finds Wright, the substitute. Andre Wright beaten by Danny Lowe. Picked up by Anthony Dudley, who takes it past one but can't take it past the second. Dudley, who scored that fourth a couple of moments ago. Now Torquay on the halfway line. Butler plays it square. Nice 1-2 with Young. The ball down the right-hand side, but intercepted by Toulson, but his control just lets him down, urged on by the home fans here in this main stand. Butler throws infield, gets the ball back as Torquay look to get the ball back. You can see Guiseley shielding the sun from their eyes as they defend, and the ball goes up in towards the edge of the penalty area. Beaten to it by Young, by Adam Boys. Good defending again. The ball away, up in the air. Jehagen will win it. Sinclair cutting a pretty lonely figure up front at the moment for Guiseley. The ball back with Torquay. They want to press, and Guiseley have set themselves into defensive duties. I think we need to press further forward again.
But yeah, we can't
yet.
Sit back, can we?
Gehring now, who headed just wide. He plays the ball forward. Sorry, Chris. Too nervous to do this properly, aren't we? Ball to the right-hand side. Right, the substitute cuts in field. He's up against Danny Lowe. Lowe puts a superb tackle in on right. What a tackle there from Danny Lowe. Gets the ball away. Intercepted well by Racky, though, before it could find its way through to Sinclair. Racky takes the ball down in midair and then plays it to the right-hand side, to right. In field here to Courtney Richards. Played back onto the circle, the centre circle, to Gehring. Square again now to Butler. Everybody inside the Lions half as the visitors press, looking to get back into this game for simple purposes of pride. It goes across to Harrod. He takes a shot, and it's 4-3. A ball simply into the box, but Guiseley just didn't follow the flight of it defensively, and it found its way all the way through to Sean Harrod. And Guiseley again find themselves reduced to a single goal lead in this game, and Sean Harrod couldn't have had an easier chance than that.
It was a great finish. Take nothing away from the finish, though. Smashed it on the volley. But we don't do things easy here, do we? Guiseley succumb a two-goal lead back to just the one.
3-0 up in this game. This would be horrendous to lose out because we didn't win it. But at the moment, Torquay are back again in their pomp and their ascendancy after Guiseley had a little spell just leading up to the goal. And now Torquay look like they're going to get back into the Lions' half and press once more. They look the more likely of the sides, two sides, to have scored the whole of the second half. And
they're going to make their third and final change very shortly. It's number four, Josh Rees, who's going to come on. Wait and see who the man coming off is. It's not happening just yet anyway.
Luke Young, I think, will be the change. But they're not doing it just yet. Like you say, they're letting it go on. Takes a deflection as Adam Boys manages to get it over the halfway line. Out of play. It's going to be a Guiseley throw just inside the Torquay half. We need the fifth now, don't we?
Yes, in a word.
I think this has been one of the most painful afternoons of football I've ever experienced so far. We've got another change. 12 minutes to go.
I've changed apps.
Have
I'm
you?
Now relying on a betting app, which has live in-play everything for Halifax versus Macclesfield, because it's the quickest and probably the most up-to-date source I can find.
Toulson throws the ball forward as Guiseley make the ball work in the Torquay half. It's surely a Guiseley throw. No, it's out for a Torquay throw. And they're urging the team on. It's a long one forward. Helped away. And Guiseley managed to help it back to the back line. But again, there's a free kick going to be given against Hatfield. Oh, it's a for Guiseley. It's actually against Torquay. Will Hatfield went down. I must admit, it looked like Hatfield had perhaps clipped his opposite number. But instead, Hatfield's on the ground. And a free kick is going to be Guiseley's.
Yeah, and the first man to complain about that being given was Danny Rackett.
It's hard to think what to say, isn't it, at the moment? It's just so nerve-wracking. Guiseley have just looked so fragile at the back after being so dominant in the first 45. We were basically preventing Torquay from coming forward with any purpose. But since the second half, they've found spaces on the wings. They've found ability to put the ball in the box with Jehagen in ways that we just didn't see.
You appear to be forgetting one key thing here, Colin. We're Guiseley. We don't do things easily. We do not do things easily at all.
10 minutes to go. Free kick now to Guiseley, though, midway through the Torquay half, and it's going to be Gavin Rothery. He'll float this one in. We've got four or five players on the edge of the 18-yard box, and it's Rothery. Chips it up in the air, up towards the back post, but it's going to be defended There's some tall players in the back line for Torquay, and now they're on the counter-attack, and they play it long. The long ball over the top, so effective for them. Sean Harrod just pushes Gavin Rothery, and it was a super ball forward, it has to be said. But Gavin Rothery, I think, you know, you have to recognise the effort and the endeavour of him there to work his way back and be the one man who is picking up Harrod there on that counter-attack. But it was a super ball forward, and fortunately for Guiseley, Sean Harrod just nudged Rothery, and it's a free kick. Ball forward now, up towards Emil Sinclair. He can't win the header. Jake Lawler goes battling. Guiseley need to get win this possession. Rothery can't. It's up here towards Wright. Wright lets it bubble underneath his feet. Danny Lowe collects. He can't keep it in play, though. It's out for another Torquay throw on the halfway line. Danny Boschel just puts the ball behind his back to prevent the quick throw from Torquay.
Did Josh Rees ever come on, by the way?
Yes, I think he did in the end. Yes, he has.
That passed
Third
me
substitution
by.
Has happened. Now, Gio Hagen into to the feet of Josh Rees, who is on the field. Out to the right-hand side. Wright gets into the box, takes a deflection, come behind for a Torquay corner. These are very worrying times for Guiseley whenever there is a corner, because they have such aerial presence in Gio Hagen and Gehring. Guiseley have looked fragile from set pieces this season. And now this one on the right-hand side, a cheaply conceded corner and a chance for Torquay to get back on level terms. The ball into the box. Everyone inside the six-yard box. It's in there. Gehring heads over and behind for a goal kick.
We breathe a slight sigh of relief as we see that header go over. 82 minutes gone.
8 minutes to go. We did need to keep that goal. Two goal cushion, I feel, is what we need. If we can just get another one, if we could sneak a fifth, goodness me, that might help. 8 minutes to go.
I'd take a mild sedative. That'd help me right now.
I need more than a mild one. The ball's been returned into Guiseley half. Harrod is up in a running race with Tilson. He's beaten him. Great save from Stephen Drench. One-on-one with Harrod. Brilliant save to deny Sean Harrod from what would have been his second of the afternoon. Hoofed away by Ryan Tilson. Out for a throw, but Guiseley undone again by the simple ball over the top. Sean Harrod just kept running. And Guiseley are grateful to the goalkeeper. The ball back in now, though. Blissett, he's got it. But it's intercepted now by Rothery. Picked up here by Lawler. Up towards the halfway line.
We're just not getting out, are we?
Won again by Verma, and you're right. We're just not getting out of our lines. We're sitting too deep. Jake Lawler tries to tackle. But again, it takes a deflection. Kindly for Torquay every single time. We've got to battle and win this ball. Rothery shows the way. He steps in. Wins it. Hatfield tries to send it up quick towards Sinclair. Doesn't work on that occasion. Sinclair needs to battle and get involved here to try and win the ball back. Dudley is. And then is Rothery once again, and a free kick has been given to Guiseley. This is agonising.
It's worse than that. This is absolute torture. Absolute torture.
6 minutes, 20 seconds of normal time to go. We're all glued to the game at Halifax. We're glued to this game. Both hang by a knife edge. Lions leading 4-3. We should have been out of sight here. The free kick is taken, and somehow Emil Sinclair's found himself in an offside position. Blaise groans it. And moans. How on earth have we conceded that position up to a Torquay free kick? It's taken quickly. Butler now. He's got it in left back. Launches it forward. Up towards Harrod again. Good header this time from Rob Atkinson. Under pressure. Will Hatfield scoops the ball up in the air. Boys needs to win it. He does. Finds Gavin Rothery. Rothery under pressure from Racky. Works ever so hard. It'll be a throw into Guiseley as it goes out of play. Rothery just rolls it behind him and leaves it to Toulson. I just feel there's a late goal somewhere. There's going to be a late goal, surely, in one of these two games. Just which way will it go? I'm absolutely convinced there'll be something. Sinclair picks the ball up for Guiseley from the throw, lays it out to the right-hand side. Rothery goes down towards the corner flag with it. He's got two on top of him, looking to win the ball off him. And we can't see down in there as the tussle begins. It's won by Racky, and he gets it clear. Up towards Blissett inside the Guiseley half. A lovely ball over the top for Blissett to return onto. Rob Atkinson is pushed over by Blissett. Free kick to Guiseley. And breathe a sigh of relief on that, because Blissett just looked like he might just be about to rob Rob Atkinson of the ball. But fortunately, it's a Guiseley free kick. 4 minutes and 30 seconds left to go. 4-3 to Guiseley here. And it's 1-1 between Halifax and Macclesfield. 3-0 to Boreham Wood over Welling. And Braintree are beating Altrincham by 3-0. The tension unbearable. Free kick for Stephen Drench to take for Guiseley. Launches this long up towards the edge of the 18-yard box. Boys chases. Sinclair wins it. Tackled for a moment by Gehring. Sinclair crosses from the right, finds infield, finds Adam Boys in the box. He tries to dink the goalkeeper. It's a poor and tame effort in the end, straight at the keeper, who can throw it out to right. Good interception from Danny Lowe. Brings the ball back to Guiseley's to the Torquay half. Right works ever so hard. Lowe well ever so hard Lowe. Works this one. Sinclair tries to win the loose ball, but it spins away from him awkwardly. And then there's a free kick to Guiseley as Gavin Rothery is bundled over by Danny Rackie. And you can hear the appreciation of Rothery's effort there. But what great, great commitment and endeavour there from Danny Lowe down that left flank.
Absolutely. Great work by a man who's been superb all season, Danny Lowe. And Guiseley. I don't know what to say anymore.
Expert punditry here from Guiseley Radio for both of us. We don't know what to say. The nerves are jangling horrendously. 3 minutes to go. Free kick to Guiseley. 4-3 up. We're watching the other score because that's pivotal. The ball square now to Hatfield. Hatfield lays it back to Rothery. Guiseley don't go for the ball into the box, and in the end might regret that because they can't get the ball out of their feet now under pressure from Torquay, and have lost it at the key moment. There's players still forward. Torquay surge over the halfway line. This could be crucial now for the Lions. It's out to the left hand side. Butler, he's going to be held up by Adam Boys. Guys, you need to get bodies back. Butler wants to get the ball in there early. Boys sticks to his task, sticks one good tackle in, then is bundled over. Free kick to Guiseley, and what excellent defending there from Adam Boys, and a yellow card to Daniel Butler to boot.
Yeah, that's great work from Adam Boys. And Dan Butler effectively just grabbed him by his shoulders from behind and slung him out the way. Picks up a booking. I expect for a combination of foul and the words that he had in the direction of the referee.
2 minutes, 10 seconds of normal time.
Five and a half left at the Shea.
The next 10 minutes... Well, who knows? Will we be celebrating? Will we be commiserating it going right down to the final moments? The ball forward from Drench up towards Sinclair. Helped away. And bowls out towards Tulson. Tulson is forced to launch the ball over the bar here, over the stands here, and away. It's going to be a throw in. And the problem with this is you know who's going to come forward and take this. Exodus Gierhagen. He's going to launch this one in. Butler leaves it. A minute and 30 to go. And Guiseley now need to set themselves once more to defend a set piece. These throws are just as good as corners. Gierhagen leans against the barriers. Launches one in. Headed away. Behind for another corner to Torquay. Harrod urges the fans to urge his side on. Torquay will take this with Danny Rackie on the left-hand side. This time they're not crowding round the six-yard box, but there's a line of four at the back post. Rackie will take this one. Into the near post, headed away brilliantly. Guys, you need to chase it and get the second ball out here. They're still set deep. Ryan Tulson tries to block the cross. It comes back in. There has a hesitation. Blasted over the bar from close range. I think it was Harrod or Gehring who got there. Guys, he get away with one right at the death there. It was a decent ball in towards the back post, but the Lions just didn't follow the flight of the ball again. Probably miscited by the low sun. Once again, that time, Torquay should have been level.
Quite right, they should. They had everybody in as the ball came out from the corner, sent straight back in by the visitors. Somehow somebody got a touch on that to put it over the top of the crossbar. Stephen Drench didn't move. He was living very, very dangerously there, as were Guiseley.
10 seconds, and then it's stoppages. 10 seconds. And we'll find out how much we've got to hold on for, because at the moment that's what the Lions are doing.
Five
minutes goes up. Sinclair through on goal. The ball goes through as everyone watches the 5 minutes and berates the referee. I don't know where he's found 5 minutes from, but the ball goes forward again, headed up in the air by Atkinson. Earth has he found 5 minutes from? I have no idea.
To be fair, four goals, three substitutions for Torquay, two for Guiseley. You're talking 30 seconds a pop there.
At the same time, Sinclair almost went through on goal but couldn't reach the ball. And then now, it's a throw-in. And every time the ball goes out for a throw anywhere near about 40 yards up from goal,
it's basically a corner.
It's a set piece. The throw will come. Gierhagen will launch. The tension, again, unbearable. We've had 45 seconds of the five added. Gierhagen again lofts this one in. Guiseley playing into the low sun, struggling to clear their lines. They managed to get it away with Jake Lawler, but only as far as Gierhagen, who gets it back into the box again. A shot way wide from Harrod. He went to spin and hit it on the half volley, but he got his lines wrong this time. Harrod has been absolutely superb. He went down injured for a few moments.
There's going to be a Guiseley sub, and unsurprisingly, Adam Lockwood's going to come on. If ever there was a time for needing a head it clear at centre half, who you need to head and clear it. And it's Anthony Dudley, who has put a great shift in. He's absolutely run his socks off. He's been on the score sheet not once but twice in this game. He bows out with a brace.
I tell you what, the only nervousness I have about that is that we did something similar with Danny Hall against Chester.
You had to mention it.
I know, and it didn't work out on that occasion. Hall came on. And perhaps with a player with just, 2 minutes of football to play, has to have some time to set themselves when they're under pressure. Not a big fan of this.
How much is left, by your reckoning?
Well, he's going to add a little bit extra, isn't he, because we made a substitute.
There's a minute.
But we've had two gone of the five, so there's another 3 minutes.
There's a minute and a half of normal time at the show.
5 minutes added time here, and we are currently 4-3 to the good, but Torquay are pressing once again. This time Lockwood intercepts only as far as Richards. Courtney Richards gets the throw in for Torquay. So guess what? Exodus Gierhagen comes forward again. Agonising moments this for Guiseley. 3 minutes, 2.5 minutes of the five. Gierhagen sets himself to loft this one in. The Lions need to hold on here. Need to avoid conceding. It goes up. There's a free kick as Drench goes to win the ball at the near post. Gierhagen lofts his arms out wide. What have you done there, ref? I tell you what, if there's any Halifax fans listening or any of the other teams that have wanted to just check out how we're doing, Torquay have given absolutely everything to try and get back on level terms after slumping to a three-goal deficit in the first half. They have really committed themselves.
Oh, absolutely. You can, if you're Kevin Nicholson, if you're one of the 303 travelling Torquay fans, overall, you can't really argue with the performance of the second half, at least. They've been absolutely fantastic, and they've really made our lives absolute hell for the last 45 minutes.
Yes, thank you, Torquay. Well, we have just a minute and a half, but again, the ball went forward. You could sell from the goal kick. It's out for a Guiseley throw on the halfway line, by the way. The ball went forward, and Guiseley almost sunk back into their own half from the clearance.
Four minutes at the Shea added on.
Meanwhile, Rothery tries to take the ball down to the corner flag. Torquay can't get out of the lines. Emile Sinclair hesitates. Won back by Rothery. Throw in for Torquay. Up and long immediately. And away. Sinclair picks up a loose ball here. Up against Gierhagen. Spins on it. Goes to the left-hand side. Tries to use his pace to get past Verma. Verma on the ball. Plays it back to his fellow centre-half, actually, Danny Rackey, who can launch this one long once again. 4 out of 5 have been played. Torquay set themselves to come forward one more time, perhaps. Danny Rackey tries to pick the ball out. Back here to Gehring. Gehring, long ball forward. The Lions struggle to deal with these all day. Dealt with by all the second half, rather. Dealt with by Atkinson. Picked up now by Verma. Again, the Lions set themselves on the edge of the 18-yard box. Atkinson gets a firm header in. Boyce needs to hoof it away. Sinclair needs to earn his corner here and win the ball. Knocked it on, lobs it on, and then chases after it. Goes back to the goalkeeper. Goalkeeper blasts it out, looking to get to right. Right misses it, and Guiseley just battle to try and keep it from going out for a throw, and they do, and it's going to be a Lions throw with 10 seconds of the added five. We wait to see what is happening at Halifax. We wait to see whether we can hold out this last minute or so. 4 minutes of stoppage time. I'm glad it's not 2 minutes, two minutes there, otherwise I might have taken offence. Guys, he managed to clear. 4 minutes still, one each. The Lions need to hold on. Still, the game goes on. The ball cleared. Sinclair needs to chase. Referee looks at his watch. 20 seconds over. The referee still doesn't blow his watch. 5 minutes into stoppage time. The ball forward again. Jake Lawler wins the header. Referee blows the watch. Huge cheers around Guiseley, but the celebrations are premature. We need to see what happens at Halifax. Tremendous performance from Guiseley this afternoon. 4-3 victors.
Two minutes still to go at the Shay.
Well, 2 minutes left to go, and we'll keep you with that until we find out what's happened. But Ollie Johnson has cut us off to a flyer. He scored after 4 minutes. Hatfield after 10. Anthony Dudley after 30. We thought we were home and dry, but in the second half, it was a resurgent Torquay United that came out. Nathan Blissett scoring after 52. Toby Ajala after 60. And then Sean Harrod after 76, but he only brought it back to 4-3 because Anthony Dudley had scored the goal that made it 4-3. We need to wait and see, though, what is happening at Halifax. Chris, tell us.
It is still 1-1. They are into added time. There is, by my reckoning, to the final minute. And Halifax have hit the post in added time as well.
You can feel a funny sense around the ground. Nobody's going anywhere. There's not a single Guiseley fan that has left. I think we're waiting to listen for this final score. There's agonizing waits around the ground. Everyone's tuning in to Twitter, to the internet, to BBC.
30 seconds of any time left.
30
going off my sources.
Goodness me, this is agonizing. Guiseley could be staying up if Halifax don't score in the next 30 seconds. It's finished Welling 0, Boreham Wood 3. Finished Woking 2, Eastleigh 1. Everyone in agony here at Nethermoor, hoping. It's a big, big if yet to come. We wait and hope that there is no further score. Finished here, if you're just joining us, it's finished here. Guiseley have won.
It's finished.
By 4-3. Then we're hearing.
It's finished!
And it's finished! Yeah! Guiseley are staying up! Guiseley are in the final of the National again next season! 80 Towers! Charles over here! The Lions have done the miracle! We have overcome! The crowd come onto the pitch to celebrate! The Lions are playing Vanarama National Football next season! Guiseley are going to be here again! What a superb afternoon here at Nethermoor! One that will live long into the memory! A pitch invasion now! Halifax go down! Guiseley have survived!
We are staying in the National League! Thank you very much, Macclesfield Town. Where do we send the flowers and champagne? We send them to Moss Rose.
Absolutely unbelievable. Here we have a crowd charging onto the field, celebrating. And I tell you what, I just want to spend a moment here to reflect what wonderful opponents Torquay United have been. There was no question they were on their holidays today. They really battered us that second half. But Guiseley have prevailed. Guiseley are staying in the Vanarama National. This is absolutely super. What an afternoon.
This is better than Charlie. Perhaps it's up there.
Well, it's a playoff final, isn't it, of sorts. This is just unbelievable. What an afternoon of football we have witnessed this afternoon. 4-3 to Guiseley. We were clinging on. Halifax scored at halftime. We knew it was irrelevant. 3-0 at the break, but it was irrelevant because if that score stayed that way, 80 Towers clutched to the cuddle with his daughter. What a wonderful afternoon. Si Wintle, some people here. I tell you what, this is wonderful. And one of the people I'm thinking of right now, Craig Shearston.
Absolutely.
How much would he have loved this? You know, this, what a fantastic finale to this season. Of course, the Craig Shearston Player of the Season trophy is going to be announced after the game, and what a party we're going to have tonight.
Absolutely, we've done it. Commiserations to Halifax.
No, it's seriously, commiserations. They're good people there, and honestly, I'd actually hoped Boreham would go down just because of the geographical thing, but But, you know, they were decent folk. You know, it's so hard, isn't it? It's really cruel to go down on this last day of the season. What the elation here. Oh, my goodness me. Unbelievable. Dave Kendra.
Thanks, Colin. What a day. What a day. I don't think we can say it enough. We can't say it enough. Guiseley are staying in the Vanarama National League. 4-3 winners this afternoon and a 1-1 draw. Halifax, if I'm cracking up a bit, it's because the elation is incredible around Nethermoor. And when the news broke that Halifax Macclesfield had finished 1-1 and the Lions were safe, the crowd raced onto the pitch. There were players doing cartwheels in the centre circle. They're still on the pitch, the fans. Simon Wintle's been lifted above someone's head there. I hope they don't drop him. Chris,
we are staying up. Say we are staying up.
Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Absolutely magical. I mean, what a game. What a game to do it. Full credit to Torquay United. We thought a few times in that second half that they were going to completely ruin the day for us.
Well,
because
they really gave
everything in that second half.
They threw everything but the kitchen sink at us in that second half. And, you know, they
I am now a Macclesfield Town fan.
We are.
And I don't care who knows it.
Come on, thanks Macclesfield. Again, you know, commiserations to Halifax. Commiserations to Altrincham. There is always a flip side to the joy that we're feeling here at Nethermoor today. You know, I'm sure we'll see our friends at Halifax again. But we're getting quite a few messages. Look, Chris, right, come on, business. Let's confirm this. Let's go through some of these scores. Right, there were other football games.
Which do you want to do, table or scores?
I want to do table.
Right, I'll do the scores. Okay. So, Vanarama National League scores for the final day of the season. Barrow 2, Wrexham 0. Braintree 3, Altrincham 0. See, it didn't cost them anywhere. Bromley 1, Aldershot 3. Cheltenham 3, Lincoln City 1. Chester 4, Gateshead 2. Dover 0, Forest Green 1. Guiseley 4, Torquay 3. And Halifax 1, Macclesfield 1. So Halifax do go down. Elsewhere, Southport 3, Kidderminster 4. We weren't the only ones in a thriller tonight. Tranmere 1, Grimsby 0. Welling 0, Bournemouth 3. And Woking 2, Eastleigh 1. Dave, the table.
The table on the final day of the Vanarama National League reads from the bottom as such. Welling on 24th place with 35 points. Kidderminster in 23rd with 40 points. Altrincham fail at the last, 44 points. Halifax in 21st place with 48 points. And the Lions in 20th place, 49 points. They survive by 1 point. We'll not say any more about that. Boreham Wood, 50 points and 19th place. And Torquay finished the season on 51 points. Guiseley will be playing a second season in the Vanarama National League.
We get to talk to Torquay again next season.
We get to talk to Torquay again next season. We get to, well, all the adventure. We get to play York City. I'd forgotten about York City.
Yes.
That's fantastic. A day out at Bootham Crescent. York's a fantastic city as
and
well.
And now we just want Harrogate to come up through the playoffs.
Yep, Harrogate, who've confirmed their place this afternoon in the National North playoffs. So they might be joining us next season. We might get that Christmas and New Year doubleheader back. You never
Excellent.
Know. I always particularly enjoyed that one.
Right. Should we wrap this up?
Let's wrap this up. Let's have a pint. Chris.
Check out the Guiseley Twitter page. Of course, there'll be lots of interviews. I know Colin's done a runner to go and get Mark, and then no doubt we'll get a few of the players as well. Tom's in there as well.
You can tweet us at Guiseley Radio all through the summer. We might even be going on tour. We've got tickets for Euro 2016, so Ooh. We might take Guiseley on tour. But tweet us your thoughts. Tweet us your feelings. Tweet us at Guiseley Radio your pictures of what you are doing to celebrate this momentous day as Guiseley secure their place. I can't say it enough. Guiseley are staying up. They're in the Vanarama National League again. I can't say it enough. Tweet us. Check us out on the Facebook page with the Guiseley AFC Radio.
Do you want to do your thank yous?
I will do my thank yous. Thank you to Colin and Chris for this afternoon. Thank you to Nick Keefe, Nick Sharp, Sandy Beeson, and everyone and anyone who has contributed to Guiseley Radio over the course of the season. Listen, we're going to go and have a big old drink tonight, and it's well deserved. By 1 point, Guiseley remain in the National League. Come on, you Lions!